3 of a best of 3 series. The starting goaltenders tonight, the Soviets will go with the veteran 28-year-old Sergei Milnikov. He's 5-0 in this tournament, a 2.36 goals against average. Grant Fuhr has played in all 7 previous games for Canada, and he has a 3.15 goals against average and is seemingly unperturbable in there.
As far as the Soviet team is concerned, they've made one major change. They have benched veteran Vasily Perepukin and Igor Kravchuk, a youngster, 21 years of age, who's been bothered by a knee problem, is in the lineup on defense. Mike Keenan, meanwhile, has Rick Tocchet dressed for tonight's game, and he will play tonight. How much, we don't know. This comes after a quick flight to Philadelphia to have his knee injury checked out. They say he cannot damage the knee further. And so Tocchet is on the bench, and you think he's not ready for tonight's game. And there are the starting lineups. Very predictable. The green unit for the Soviet Union, centered by Larionov. And we'll start the game with Gretzky and Mario Lemieux together, along with Messier on the forward line.
And every time you see Larionov out there, you usually see Messier against him, and that's the way we start. Kurutov in across the line for Makarov. Centering pass, Messier back checking, gives it to Gretzky. Behind the back pass for Lemieux, but it's shot out of there by Fetisov. Now to Larionov. Larionov leaving it for Makarov. He's checked by Lemieux from behind. Now Kurutov closing in. Gretzky checked him from behind. And Gretzky winds it around. Center. They score! Makarov all alone in front of the net. Set up by Kurutov. And an early goal for the Soviets.
Doug Crossman at the side of the net let the puck come to him rather than going after the puck and found himself beaten to it. Gretzky clearing it around the net. Crossman is number 2 as Gretzky is decked. Crossman, well, the puck's already in the net, but Crossman had been beaten to the puck. Here's a better view of it. And you can see that Crossman is way out of position. The puck is stripped from him. And Makarov with the goal, and the Soviets lead.
Makarov, 7th of this tournament. So the green unit strikes early, and the Soviets lead. Here's Gretzky shooting it into center ice. Prop couldn't knock it down. And going back to the Soviets, Kumatov, he leaves it there. And here's the new man in the lineup tonight, Igor Kravchuk, clearing it into center ice. Canada's Mario Lemieux dropping it back to Doug Crossman, number 2, who fires it out of there. Kravchuk, number 29, is 21 years of age. As a matter of fact, turned 21 today, cleared it in. Canada trying to get it out of there. Soviets hold it in. Here is a drive just wide by Kumatov. And Canada then clear it out of there. But Dotov, number 14, back for the Soviets. Into center to Kanyansky, number 13. Sidestep to check. Back guns Kowarchuk, flipping it in. And the Dotov is there to clear it away. Bork tried to hold it in, couldn't. Soviets break out of there. In on the left side, Lomakin, number 23, centered it, but it comes all the way back into center ice. Here's Gusarov, number 3, flipping it. Bork knocks it down. Bork to Kowarchuk, dropping it back to Larry Murphy, number 8. Murphy slides it in. And the Soviets, Gusarov, checked by Kowarchuk. Kowarchuk trying to get up to Tocchet, but he was upended on the play. And the Soviets fire it out of there with Ramo Bork of the Boston Bruins back to get it for Canada. To Dale Kowarchuk, leaving it for Sutter, back to Kowarchuk. Scooped in, and Milnikov caught it and held it, and we'll get a face-off. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
What makes the Formula One World Champion such a great race car? Computer-programmed fuel injection. Dual overhead cams. Four valves per cylinder. What makes this such a great street car? Exactly the same technology. The Acura Integra. One of Car and Driver's 10 best. Exclusively at your Acura dealer.
Only 26 seconds. Sergei Makarov from Kurutov, who is the one who stripped the puck from Doug Crossman behind the net and fed it quickly in front. 26 seconds. Soviets leading 1-0.
Now Canada with a line of Doug Gilmour, Mario Lemieux, and Brent Sutter. Then Chinoff and Gilmour on the faceoff. Gilmour gets it to Brent Sutter. Centered to Lemieux to Gilmour. Shoots and nailed it across. Went to his knees to Rob Gilmour. Canada's best chance thus far. Soviets take possession and fire it out of there. Imelev into center ice, trying to get it ahead for Priyanka. Fiora way out of the net to clear it, and he cleared it up over the glass and into the crowd, and then some bumping on the boards by Humalap and Sutter after the whistle.
Well, Brent Sutter raising a little hob with Don Koharski. Two Stanley Cup winners for Sutter. He won't feel the pressure at all in a game of this moment. Of course, also part of the Canada Cup in 1984, and a big star for Canada in the 84 Canada Cup. Just 25 years of age, seven seasons already in the NHL. Part of a very
sure
big
has
family.
A few brothers across North America watching this one tonight. Let's see, there'd be Dwayne and Daryl in Chicago, Brian in St. Louis. Who am I missing? Rich Garon. Plus Mom and Dad and the rest of the Sutters from Viking, Alberta. Puck is cleared on the ice. Here's Doug Gilmour chipping it in. Lemieux went in after it, and Chinoff tied him up, and now Petisov loses it. Rochefort couldn't get it, and Kostatonov feeds it into center ice for Imelev. Imelev dropped pass back, and Chinoff couldn't control it. Now Priyakin can't center it. Priyakin still after it. Gets it to number eight, Imelev. Back on the point. Shot in by Nemchinov is blocked, and Canada come to center. Gretzky firing it in. Back to get it, Pasadona. That's Lemieux stealing it, but Nemchinov was there to prat it away. And the Soviets take over, and Petisov cleared it into center ice. This is Doug Crossman back near his own blue line to Coffey. Back to Crossman. Crossman puts it near the line. Shot right back out by Kravchuk, the newcomer in the Soviet lineup tonight, and that's icing against the Soviets. This is the Levant Canada Cup on CTV.
Playing hockey was a wonderful experience. Today, young Canadians are carrying on the tradition. Unfortunately, costs have increased. That's why McCormick Champagne Crackers have come to the support of minor hockey. October to December, when the young people come to your door, support them. $1 out of every package sold goes to support local teams, so everyone wins. You can enjoy the great taste of McCormick Champagne Crackers and support a Canadian tradition.
Well, there's the latest energy-saving device.
He applauded so loudly and long the other night, he brought his own applauder tonight. 1-0, the Soviets leading. And Larionov from deep in the Soviet zone to center. 3-on-2 break, led by Larionov to Makarov. Shoots, you're the save, and he bats that rebound away with his big goal set. Back comes Canada, Glenn Anderson, number 9. Anderson trying to drop it back, Stelnov intercepts. Right back, he comes the other way to Karuta. And it's Crossman clearing it, Makarov held it in. Now he's slammed into the boards by Messier, and Crossman feeds it over, and Rochefort shot at the center. Back is Stelnov. Off the boards to Larionov, back to Stelnov. Fired it out. Gartner tried to knock it down. Here's Krutov to Larionov. He's checking back the other way. Comes Howardchuk, cutting right in. Wide by about a foot. Big burst of speed by Howardchuk. And Gusarov has it for the Soviets. He tried to clear it. Bork held it in. Shot. Deflected it just wide. And Krutov slaps it down the ice to relieve the pressure. That's icing against the Soviets.
Well, Howardchuk with a very, very big chance, and you notice the march he got on the defenseman. He underrated Howardchuk's speed a little bit sometimes, but this time he really got loose, and he just beat the defenseman to the net and then just shot it a bit wide. Stole the puck at center ice. The defenseman now has turned around on the play. That's Stelnov there, and now he's got a big jump on him, and Howardchuk probably had a little bit of room to get around the defenseman and get directly in front of the goal, but he thought he was going to be under a little more pressure than he in fact was. Shot quicker than he wanted to and missed by about 5 inches.
Mike Keenan must feel Howardchuk is hot. He leaves him out there with Gretzky and Lemieux, and the Soviets clear it to center ice. Bork back to get it. to Gretzky. Over to Howardchuk. Into Lemieux, who gets pulled down by Petkoff. And Petkoff will get the game's first penalty. And Canada will have a power play. This is the Levesque Canada Cup on CTV.
Discover a new species, 1988 Chevrolet Beretta, for the way you drive today.
Today, Chevrolet
Beretta.
Going your way.
Beckhoff is off for interference at 4:59. When you take a scoring chance away, it has to be called. And there you see it right at the bottom of your screen. Mario Lemieux would have been free. Good chance unfolding for Canada. Beckhoff just hauled his man down. The penalty had to be called. Here's Coffey to Gretzky. Canada with the man advantage. Back to Coffey. Over onto the other point. Bork centered it. It's too hard for Gretzky to knock down. And now the puck comes back into Canada's zone with Coffey back to gutter. To Marc Messier. Leaving it there. And here is Bork to Coffey to Lemieux. Mario Lemieux trying to get it to Bork. Comes to Gretzky. Gretzky in the slot. Standard Owen Messier gets failed to tip it in. Now behind the net to Lemieux. Mario Lemieux, number 66, to Gretzky. Back to Coffey. Into Lemieux, but intercepted by Kostadinov. And the Soviets shorthanded top to center ice. Kostadinov doing a good job. Cleared it in, and Bork is back to get it. A minute 8 left in the Soviets' penalty. Bork to Coffey. Soviets have scored a shorthanded goal in each of the 3 games against Canada, so keep that in mind. They shoot it in. Petisov back to get it, firing it out of there. And Bork will have to chase back. 50 seconds left in the penalty. Bork just slaps it in. And Milnikov out of the goal, handed it right to Anderson. Now to Gretzky. Gretzky cutting in, trying to center. Delno broke it up. Now Gretzky out in front. In front, Goulet shot, rebound. Blocked out by Anderson, and Milnikov got a piece of that. And it's cleared away. Again, the puck artistry and the playmaking of Gretzky. Here is Coffey. Into Gretzky. Trying to hit Goulet in the slot. Soviet clear it, knocked down by Hartsburg. To Gretzky. In front, Goulet offended in the slot. And Gusarov gets out of there. 2-on-1, Soviet break. Coffey trying to get back. Here's the shot. Off the goal post. Oh, and Gusarov, now they put the red light on. I think it went in the net. Gusarov indicated he had scored, but the red light did not come on. Then it did. And let's see what Koharski rules here. They're signaling the face-off at center ice. I thought it went in the net and came out. But the light did not go on, and then it came on very briefly and went out again. Koharski has signaled there's a goal, and we've got a... Well, let's take a look at it here now. Off the post, right there and right inside the net. So it went all the way around and came back out. So you're right, it hit a post, but then rattled around inside the cage before coming out.
2-0, the Soviets lead. Here's James Patrick trying to feed it to Doug Gilmore. Poked away by Milnikov, Sutter in to get it, and now Priyakin, number 22, into center to them, Chinov, number 12. And that's offside at the blue line. Lumalev in ahead of the play. This is the Levesque Canada Cup on CTV.
Professor, I found something.
A primitive hammer. Excellent condition.
When man makes something well, it lasts a long, long time.
Find something?
Did you drop your hammer here?
Not me. It's probably Joe. He's always dropping things.
Mastercraft hand tools from Canadian Tire. They're guaranteed forever.
This program is protected by copyright. Any use of this telecast without permission is prohibited. 2-0, the Soviets lead that last scoring play. Gusarov unassisted at 7:04, just after the Soviet player, 5 seconds after he had come back onto the ice from serving a penalty. So it wasn't a shorthanded goal. But an early jump for the Soviets, a 2-0 lead. Here's Petisov clearing it into center ice. Messier knocks it down. Got it into the corner. Petisov now to Makarov, to Larionov. Larionov leaving it for Kurutov. He's checked by Anderson. And Anderson and Gardner try and wedge it out of there on the boards, but play has halted. And the faceoff will come at the Team Canada blue line.
Brought back in over the line with players trapped as we look at Glenn Anderson, bothered by a knee injury early. And that's maybe the first good body check of the period as he nails Kurutov right up against the boards there. Puck came out over the line, came back in, and that produced the whistle. Shots on goal, Canada with 5, Soviet Union 3. Have scored on 2 of the 3.
Here's Makarov. Makarov beating Petisov, closing in. Shoots, he scores! Petisov from Makarov. It's 3-0 for the Soviets.
Oh, the mastery and the wizardry of Makarov, who hung onto that puck, and then just gave it right here. And the overloading of the zone with Petisov coming in. He was had a clear path to the net, and it's 3-0. And Canada is in shock here at the 8-minute mark. The Soviets have just completely scored and everything. So Petisov, on every chance that they have had, they have scored.
3-0, the Soviets lead. Canada in game one came from behind a 4-1 deficit to tie it, but it was much later. Here are the Soviets, who are off to the quick start, feeding to Kamienski. Kamienski, number 13, trying to move in. He gets knocked around. Now Bekov, checked by Howardchuk before he could shoot. Bekov again to Stelno. Hartsburg trying to tie him up. Stelno still with it. Gets it in front. Fewer the save. And then Lemieux cleared it. Gretzky dropping it back. And it's back to Gretzky. Gretzky for Canada. Leaves it for Lemieux. Here's Lemieux to Gretzky. To Mario Lemieux. Lemieux for Canada. That long reach, trying to go to a one-handed move, loses it, and Semyonov had it for the moment. Canada still holding in. Gretzky looks for Lemieux. Lemieux to Gretzky, and that's broken up. And now Lemieux shoots Gretzky at the edge of the crease, couldn't tip it in. And the Soviets break up. But now back to the play, a penalty goal for cross-checking against the Soviet Union. And Canada get a bit of a break there because the Soviets were breaking up 2-on-1.
I'm not sure a penalty was called on 99 Gretzky with the one side of the net. The other side of the net was knocked to the ice. Canada guilty of overhandling the puck a little bit. Gretzky, what a chance. Simply just, well, he was covered up very quickly right at the side of the net as Semyonov came over. And there's Gretzky going down under the checking. And Kravchuk, the young defenseman, picks up the minor. And Canada really has to score here.
3-0, the Soviets leading. Makarov, Gusarov, and then Petisov for Makarov on their third goal. Here's Goharski, the referee, and another tribute to him. The Soviets agreeing to a Canadian official in this game, which usually sees neutral officials operate, at least from neutral countries. All officials are neutral, right, Ron?
Exactly. All NHL officials seem to be.
Canada on the power play. They're 0-for-1 in this game tonight with the man advantage, and they're down by 3. Now Messier. Over to Murphy. Murphy moving in, and Canada goes offside at the Soviet blue line.
Mark Messier on the far side getting in a little too quickly. The penalty to Kravchuk at 9:10 for cross-checking. A look at Mark Messier. What a first period he had the other night. Set the tone of the game with his hitting, speed. And while he seemed to slowly run out of steam, he really picked up his own teammates. see him on the bench. He's a clear leader, not only the Edmonton Oilers, but Team Canada as well.
Canada with the man advantage. Bourque and Murphy, the point men, with Anderson, Goulet, and Tocchet up front. Puck dumped in by Bourque. Now Anderson digs in against Batisoff. Makarov there to clear it. Knocked down by Canada. Here's Murphy. Chase Steele to cop the same rebound.
No finesse at all. Murphy again gets it in the slot. This time he elected to shoot. It got behind Molnikov, and Tocchet trailing on the play picked up the loose puck. I thought that Team Canada was guilty of overhandling the puck a lot. Just get the shot, go in and look for rebound. That's the way you play the game over here. And Tocchet was there, got the rebound, and Canada's getting got a very important goal on a power play.
Rick Tocchet gets the goal, his third of this series.
Assisted by number 16, I had the ill say, Michel Goulet.
Goulet will get an assist, as will Murphy. Here's Canada with Murphy leading the attack, trying to get it to Anderson, broken up, and Hovetov, number 15. Hovetov into center ice, gets it to Bekov, number 27. Now to Hovetov, back to Bekov. He's upended by Sutter, and Brent Sutter will get a penalty here. And now Canada will be shorthanded, holding against Sutter. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Pontiac Tempest joins the Pontiac Heatwave.
Heat is on. It's the Pontiac beat, and the beat's alive.
Introducing the all-new 1988 Pontiac Tempest, a compact sedan that'll blow the competition out of town.
Oh, 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 tell me, can you feel it? Tell me, can you feel it? Pontiac, the heat is on, it's on the street.
Sutter goes off for holding just seconds after Canada had gotten on the board. That's Bekov, number 27, and it just got the clutch put on him by Sutter. Not an opportune penalty. Canada trying to get some momentum going. Trailing 3-1 in the game. Canada's really got the edge in terms of offense. They just haven't been able to get Molnikov. 10-5 shots on goal right now for Team Canada.
But 3-1 for the Soviets. Canada able to clear it out of there. But Dotov back to get it into his own zone. Now dropping it back to Dotov again as Kamienski gave it to him. Return to Kamienski, number 13. To Bekov, number 27. To Hovetov, number 15. Now to Dotov, and his pass across to Gusarov. Tipped away by Messier. Gusarov over to Bekov. Drops it. Hovetov checked in. Here's Gilmore for Canada. Gartner shoots right on. Glove save Milnikov as Gilmore put Gartner into the right side. Back comes Bekov to Hovetov. Hovetov around Rochefort moving in. Gilmore trying to tie him up. Now to Batisoff at the point. Back on the boards. Soviets with the power play. Behind the net. Put right through the crease and Kasatonov. Missed it at the edge of the crease, and now Hovetov down on the ice and shaken up, and that's why play has been halted.
Rather desperate situation for Team Canada as Gartner has been playing that whole sequence without his stick. His stick lying broken down on the ice. Hovetov went down to the side of the net with that little shot, which was something more than just a little shot. Gotta get in front of the net. They're prepared to pay the price a little bit. Oh, Hovetov goes to the bench. Seventh season veteran. And his third Canada Cup. Like Bekov, very small and shifty, but quite a hockey player.
They call him the Soviet rat, huh? I know the
we never told him.
I know the hit was a little illegal, but the fall was rather dramatic too, as well.
Yeah. Well, you see, Bill Barber played. I learned a few things.
3-1, Soviets leading. 57 seconds left in Canada's penalty. Kasatonov back to get it. To Kurutov. into Larionov, and that play is offside at the Soviet blue line.
Good check at the line. Kurtov took a good shot. This is a good, clean hit. This is what hockey's about. Boom. Two tough guys against Kurtov. He'll take those checks and come right back at you, but so will Messier.
Green number 11. He is strong.
The guy was on his way back to his feet. The whistle went on the offside.
Still 44 seconds left in Canada's penalty to Sutter. Messier out there against Larionov on this faceoff. Well, those two fellas have got to know each other very well during this 1987 Canada Cup. Larionov just gets to know Messier a little bit better as he gives him a jab from the faceoff. Bork trying to clear it, but Tisot held it in. Shot blocked by Bork to Anderson. Anderson tied up by Tisot. Now knocked away from Anderson. And Canada having to drop back with Larry Murphy. Murphy loses to Makarov, but as soon as Makarov touched the puck, it was called on a delayed offside.
Very smart play by Murphy. He knew he had the free pass on the delayed whistle, so he circled back inside his own zone. Moment as Soviet touched the puck, the whistle was going to go anyway, so he killed off some precious seconds, and the power play situation for the Soviet now is down to 21 seconds. Now Murphy, knowing there's a delayed whistle here, circles back. Killed off 4, 5, 6 seconds, maybe the difference. Finally, Makarov moved in and checked him.
21 seconds left in the penalty, Hartsburg for Canada. Clears it away, Gilmore and Gartner are up front. With Rochefort and Hartsburg on defense, here's Gartner trying to center. Intercepted by Stelnov. Now to Samak, number 18. Samak shot off of Hartsburg. Rochefort beats Semyonov to it, clearing it. There's Kropchuk pinching in to Semyonov. Now Lomakin back of the net with Samak. Samak trying to center to Lomakin. Back to Stelnov. Shooting, that's just wide. Bounced in front, and Gilmore couldn't get it out of there. Semyonov held it in. Well, Mackin has it, but now Brent Sutter out of the penalty box. Canada back at full strength. And here's Sutter trying to break away. Sutter gets knocked down. Gretzky follows up. Cleared it in. Delno. Bumped by Gretzky. Delno flipping it. And into center ice. Samak loses, and here's Howardchuk trying to get it to Lemieux. Samak to Lomakin, and Coffey took it away from him. Trying to get it to Gretzky, Lomakin intercepts. And the Soviets with Kropchuk shoot it into Canada's zone. Fuhr clears it out. Here's Lemieux. Into Howardchuk. Gusarov back to get it. Clearing it out onto the boards. Priyakin shoots it to center. Rothman over for Coffey. Now to Gretzky. Ahead on the wing for Howardchuk. And that's intercepted by Priyakin. Canada again in control. Stick handling in neatly as Howardchuk to Lemieux, but offside is the play at the Soviet blue line. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
When you look around, most every place you go, city and country, there's a taste you'll know, and so more and more.
Gobbled up in very short order, and the scalpers have been having a field day ever since. Reminder, during our first intermission, Doug Gilmore is going to be around. We'll have some highlights of the first two games of this championship round. Set the music. They're pretty spectacular, too. Brad Park will have his highlights on the Toyota scoreboard with Dan Kelly.
Here's Team Canada down 3-1. Michelle Goulet firing it in, and Petisov back to get it. Petisov to Bekov. Now to Kamienski. Kamienski upended, but clears it to Team Canada's line. Coffey fired it back out. Here's Kaminsky. Over to Homotop, number 15. He just jumps it in. Murphy back for Canada. Murphy missing Coffey with a pass. Here's Bekov to Homotop. Homotop flips it in. Now Muir giving it to Gretzky. Winding it around under the boards. Batisov pinching in. Batisov centered, loose in front. Canada come up with it, and here's Lemieux to Gretzky. Gretzky with Lemieux. Upended on the play is Gretzky, and Bekov has it. Now Kopp holding it in. Kapitonov back to go. Right in front of his own goal to Batisov. And the Soviet veteran defenseman Batisov to Makarov to Bekov. Back to Makarov, right in. Muir came out and made a big save. As Makarov was right in at the doorstep. Now a pass to Tockett, misses him. And the Tonoff back to get almost stolen by Canada on the play as Kropp got his stick on it. Now here's Bork from center ice firing it in. Back is Delno. Into port deck is Tockett. Rick Tockett. Gets some help from Brent Sutter out in front. They score!
Bad start for Canada, but they're back in it. Kropp is on the goal side at this side of the net. Here's a closer view. Kropp is number 26, looks to the right of the net. Now he moves into position. Out comes Sutter, throws it across. Don't get cute. That's the story of the two goals for Team Canada. All they've done, talking again with a great job forechecking, produced the puck. And Kropp gets credit for the goal.
Brian Kropp at 15:23 here in the first period. The Soviets lead to 3-2. Tocca gets an assist. As of course is Brent Sutter. 15:23 the time. Soviets lead has been cut to 3-2. Here's James Patrick. In across the line to Messier, to Gartner. Milnikov a save, and Gusarov clears it to Lomakin, who shot at the center. Patrick giving it to Messier. Fired in. Going back, big Gusarov takes a hit from Gartner on the play. And now Semyonov at center. Into Semak. Semak trying to move in, does, shoots. Save by Fuhr on Semak. And then he sputtered it. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Taxi!
Hey, Frank, what are you doing?
Trying to catch a cab to the car rental. I rented a car for the weekend.
Yeah, me too, from Discount.
Discount?
Yeah, they picked me up and dropped me off afterwards for free.
For free?
Yeah. Come on, get in. I'll give you a lift.
Thanks.
Call Discount Car and Truck Rentals. We want your business, and we'll come right to your front door to get it.
Gartner on it, a late whistle, laid the check of the game. Right here as he just leveled, well, he didn't level him, but he sure came up against the boards on Gusarov, who's a pretty solid guy. Gartner, who played hurt through the first part of this tournament, a very sore wrist, which wouldn't allow him to shoot the puck to any great extent, met as part of his game. But he told me this morning that the problem is now cured. Hasn't really been bothering him too much. It's still sore, but at least he can control his stick. There's Messier. Feelings are running high a bit. That probably followed something else. Almost off there.
Imchinov on a face-off against Brent Sutter. Deep in Canada's zone. 4:07 left in the period. Batisov at the point. Skate saved by Fuhr, and then the rebound is just poked away. Ryokin couldn't get it in front, and here's Brent Sutter to Bork. Now tipped by Hartsburg and fired in by Tockett. Tockett has scored for Canada and set up another. Here's Tockett with a shot wide of the net. Bork flipping it in, and he flipped it up over the boards at the Soviet bench. So some of the grinders, such as Rick Tocchet, playing hurt but coming through big for Canada.
Well, I don't know who got the worst of this, but Sutter and Tocchet. I think Tocchet probably took the brunt of that check, which was originally intended for Kazatonov back there. Tocchet coming to the bench to shake it off a little bit. There's Tocchet there. Tocchet and Sutter just arriving at the bench. Boy, that Tocchet, for a guy who's supposed to have a tender knee, is really doing it. He's scored a goal. He's assisted on a goal, started the play in the corner when he dug the puck loose and got it to Sutter. It led to Propp's goal that has made it a 3-2 hockey game.
Here's Gretzky, Lemieux, and Anderson now for Canada. Coffey and Murphy on the bench. Soviets with their line of Bekov, Kamensky, and Homotov up front.
And we'd like to remind you that the Labatt player of the game for Canada will receive the new Canon EOS autofocus that never misses. Stop the game with the only autofocus camera quick enough to capture all the action. The Canon EOS, the official 35mm camera of the 1988 Olympic Winter Games.
Play just underway. Canada's shooting it in. Back to get it. Here's Lemieux stealing it in front to Anderson as Lemieux beats Propp stuck to the puck. Now Anderson tied to the net to Lemieux. And Hildekopp came out and cleared it. Gretzky to Murphy. Murphy shoots up high into the crowd. Starting to gear up.
Murphy had to do that all over again. He would have wished that the puck had come to the stick flat. I think he had a bouncing, rolling puck. He had to cradle first and then tee it up. And then, of course, the defenseman was able to move over.
We're talking about Gretzky, or as we look at Murphy, we're talking about Gretzky and Lemieux, who now lead the ice. I guess you could say Gretzky loads the gun and Mario pulls the trigger.
That's about it. It probably is a best way to describe it.
Here's Canada on the faceoff. Patrick firing it around over to pick it up to Saroff, out to Makarov, leaving it there for Fedotov, number 14. Arianov cleared it in, but it's offside as Kurupdov was in ahead of the play.
Shots on goal continue to be 2-1 favor Canada, 16-8 now. Canada with a total of 16 shots already in this game, with 2:57 remaining in the first period. Gretzky, the captain.
No, two different times, Ron, I've seen Wayne Gretzky get 5 goals in a game. I think the best game I've ever seen him play was the other night. He didn't have a goal. He had 5 assists and was all over the place.
That's great assist. There's a high stick. Makarov on and an inadvertent one on that. When Anderson was turning at the boards, and puck seemed to, you can see Makarov's reaction. Stick seemed to ride up on the stick of Anderson, cut him across the face, and there's going to be a high-sticking call. Makarov, a good call. Now, here it is. They're still responsible for your stick. And if it gets up above the shoulders, then you have to pay the price, no matter whether it's accidental or not. Canada goes on the power play.
Canada 1-for-2 with the man advantage in this game. Canada's 10th power play goal of the Canada Cup. So Canada with Lemieux, Messier, and Gretzky up front. Coffey and Bork, the point men. Here's Coffey to Messier. Leaving it for Lemieux. He left it there for Messier. Into Lemieux, back of the net to Gretzky. On the point to Bork, and then broken up by Larionov, chipped off the center. Bork has to hustle back. 2:20 left in the first period. 3-2 Soviets. Bork to Messier. Back to Bork. Ahead to Gretzky, and he just tips it in. Lemieux behind the goal. Krukov couldn't get it. Lemieux back to Bork. Around to the other side to Gretzky. Trying to tip it to Messier. And the Soviets got it. Coffey held it in. His shot wide. Here's Lemieux. To Bork, to Coffey. Over to Gretzky. Back
to Coffey. Other side to Bork. Shot blocked by Besha. Bork with 49 seconds left in the penalty to Coffey. Dick save, Mildekot. Gretzky to Coffey. Over to Lemieux. Couldn't handle a pass. To Messier, who lets it go to Gretzky. On the point to Bork. Over to Coffey. Now to Bork with 30 seconds left in the penalty. Back to Coffey. Over to Gretzky. Soviet playing that box. Side of the net to Messier. Back to Gretzky. Now to Coffey. Shooting. Mildekot save. And Mario Lemieux couldn't get the rebound. Now he does. To Messier. Messier shoots from a bad angle. Pasatonov blocked that. We're in the final minute of the period. 4 seconds left of the penalty. Gretzky to Coffey. Over to Bork. Penalized player back on. Bork lets the shot go. Blocked. And Kurucov cleared it. Now Bork a shot. Gretzky deflects. Off the goal post for Batlow. And the Soviets, Makarov clearing the center. Bork back to get it. Bork loses. Kolmatov in the clear. Scores! Kolmatov on a breakaway. And the Soviets on a late goal take a 4-2 lead here in the first period.
Well, we got back to the problem that I think that Team Canada was in the early stages of the period. They tried to get too cute. And here's Kolmatov all alone, and nearly a great save by Grant Fuhr, but it trickled over the line. Puck was just stripped away as falling on the play was Bork, and Kolmatov had the clear path. But going back to the power play, it's almost like when you get Gretzky and Messier and also Lemieux out there, they want to score the perfect goal. Take a look at the two goals that have been scored for Team Canada tonight. It's been on sheer muscle and throw it in front of the net and bang it into the net. Now, we've had Gretzky and Lemieux score great goals in this tournament, but there they were almost like they were looking for the perfect and perfect goal, and they certainly didn't get it because the Soviets had played the box perfectly.
Now Canada down by two again. 17 seconds left in the period. Prop in there digging on the board. Soviets able to clear it, and Rochefort has to go back. Rochefort just scooping it into center ice, and it goes up over the boards at the Team Canada bench with 4 seconds left in the first period. Kolmatov unassisted, 19:32, the time of that goal.
Well, we've got one of those games again, and don't go away because we've seen leads before disintegrate and go away. And the Soviets had their 3-0 lead reduced to 3-2.
There's a long shot that Mildekot handles, and he heads to the locker room with his team leading 4-2.
Shots on goal in the period. Canada outshot the Soviets 19-9, but the Soviets scored 4 goals on those 9 shots and some pretty glaring errors that led to the goals.
Just goes to show you again that shots on goal statistic is not a good one. 4-2, the Soviets lead after 20 minutes here in Hamilton. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
There's a new standard in fresh ground coffee taste. Introducing new Taster's Choice premium ground coffee. At last, the choice is yours. Selling your home can be an isolating experience. But with a Century 21 office, you may not wait long for your ship to come in.
Hello?
Rob, I'd like to bring a family over. How's Friday?
He's fine, thanks.
Mr. Crusoe, the Robinsons. They're a Swiss family, Robinson.
This place is really...
Last year, we put over 1 million buyers and sellers together, one home at a time. Century 21, the largest real estate organization in the world.
When you consider how big it is...
You know what makes it so big? All those peanuts!
It's not surprising there's so much inside.
It's that big chunk of fudge. I'm telling you, it's all that caramel. It's that big chunk of fudge.
Oh, Henry, what makes it big makes it good.
How do we get down?
What do you call a car with this much styling outside and so much room inside? What do you call a family car with the efficiency and performance of a 16-valve engine? What do you call a car the Automobile Journalists Association of Canada called the best imported sedan? What do you call a car with a 5-year, 100,000-kilometer powertrain warranty? We call it Camry. You'll call it incredible. The 1987 Toyota Camry. Who could ask for anything more? Your face takes enough abuse, so Gillette introduces the new Good News Plus disposable. Its Luber Smooth Strip is designed to reduce irritation, so shaving feels so good. New Good News Plus.
After a one period of play in Hamilton, game three of the best of three Canada Cup final, the Soviets lead 4-2. One member of Team Canada that scored a goal in each of the previous two playoff games against the Soviets joins us now, Doug Gilmore. And Doug, we were just chatting as we got in position here. It's going to be uphill again. Why is it so often uphill against these guys?
I really don't know. We talked about it in the dressing room before. It's not our game plan to come out this slow, but they've jumped all over us a couple times. And now, like you said, it's uphill again for us, and we got to be ready these next two periods there. You know, it's all going to be all over.
They were sky high in this building as this game was getting set to start. What was the feeling like in the dressing room?
We were ready. You know, the crowd is great here, but we were talking about it, but mentally we thought we were ready, but when we came on the ice, we weren't. So we just got to regroup. Everybody's got to get back together and take it shift by shift. We can't have one good shift and the next shift let down. We all got to work together as a team and keep on going.
They scored three times on their first four shots on goal. Really put you in a big hole in the first half of that period. It seemed to me as if the play of the muckers and grinders started to bring the team to life. Tockett and Sutter, the guys doing the smacking and banging.
Yeah, that's what we have to do mostly. We have to get the puck in there, and mostly the guys like Tockett on the ice and, you know, Sudsy. You just got to get the puck in there, you got to work, and keep on throwing the puck in. Hit Fedosov, hit that...
Kazatonov.
And they'll cough the puck up, those guys. You got to hit them, though. If you don't get on them quick, they're great players.
Does this team that you have on the ice right now, less Claude Lemieux, less Kevin Dineen, do you have enough hitting throughout the entire lineup? You've got a couple of hitters left.
Sure we do. You know, everybody can hit, everybody can do everything. You just got to get in there, get on them. We don't give them the puck. You got to throw it around the board where the wingers can get to it and make things happen. And I think this period we're going to come out, and it's going to be a different ballgame.
Well, we've talked during this telecast that with all the talent on Team Canada, it looks from time to time as if the players are trying to make the perfect play, the pretty play. So often that doesn't work.
A lot of times we are. You know, Mr. Pina says before every game, shoot the puck. I got in some heck the other game for not shooting the puck in the slot. And that's one thing we got to bear down on. Just keep shooting. And, you know, hopefully if it's a bad goal, who cares? You know, long as it goes in.
No, it doesn't matter how pretty it looks, it still counts. Does this team have a glaring weakness, the Soviet team? Does it have a weakness that you can work on?
I think if we box them up really quick, you know, in a sense, in the neutral ice zone, we take the man, get the puck back in there and work them, and they'll start standing around. That's the only way we're going to beat them. If they start freewheeling, we're not going to stay up with them.
Mike Keenan talks continuously, nonstop, about defensive posture. This is far too early in the hockey game to talk about opening up, I assume.
Oh, it is. For sure it is. You know, all we need is one more goal. We're back in the game, and, you know, we can work on one more after that. But we need one in the first 10 minutes of this period coming up, and we can't give them anything.
Mm-hmm. You know, normally when we introduce a player, we'd say Doug Gilmore of the St. Louis Blues plays center. On this team, it's Doug Gilmore plays any position up front. How does that feel for a player?
Feels great. All I can say, I'm on the ice. I don't care where I am, what position, as long as I get on.
Doug, thanks very much. Good luck to you. Doug Gilmore, St. Louis Blues. Team Canada trailing after one period of play to the Soviets, 4-2. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
The unique Royal LePage pre-approved mortgage. With it, shopping for your dream home is a joy. Without it, shopping for a mortgage after finding a house can be a nightmare. One you can avoid with our pre-approved mortgage. We guarantee rates equal to or lower than the five major banks. Bypass mortgage hassles. Buy your house on the spot because you're pre-approved. Ask your Royal LePage representative about our pre-approved mortgage.
Oh, when the saints go marching in, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in.
If you have a miserable cold, you deserve the hot lemon relief of Neocitrin.
Oh, when the warm comes soothing through.
Soothing, effective Neocitrin. If you have a cold, may the saint be with you.
For the best protection in a tough game, nothing tops the Cooper All Girdle except this. Introducing the new Upper Body Protector. The next step in the Cooper All system. Lightweight and comfortable, it stays with you on impact. Flexing and protecting like a second skin. Get the Cooper All Upper Body Protector, part of the Cooper All system. Because when you get hit in the game of hockey, you get hit hard.
Nobody in Canada competes like Chrysler. When you wanted the best warranty, Chrysler came through with 7-year or 115,000-kilometer protection. Now Chrysler announces dealer inventory cashbacks. $750 on Canada K. $1,000 on Chrysler LeBaron GTS Premium. $750 on Chrysler New Yorker. And many more. For warranty protection and now cashbacks, nobody competes like Chrysler.
Canada had the edge in play in that first period, but the Soviets had the edge around the goal, and they lead by a pair. But of course, one period does not a game make. Witness the first two games of this series, both of which went to overtime. 6-5 in both games, once for the Soviets, once for Canada. It's been a rock and roll affair.
Soviets, Makarov at the 26-second mark, Gusarov at 7:04, then Fetisov at 8-minute mark to make it 3-0. Canada got a power play goal from Tocket at 9:50, then Prop scoring at 15:23 to make it close, but then the late goal by Homotop at 19:32. Shots on goal, Canada 19, Soviets 9, but the scoreboard tells a much different tale. Our Toyota scoring summary brought to you by Toyota, makers of the economical fun to drive Tercel. Who could ask for anything more?
Well, look at that goal by Homotov right near the end of the period, and it could be a big, big goal for the Soviet Union. They went into the dressing room, of course, on a high. They'd seen a 3-0 lead disintegrate to 3-2. Now they lead 4-2. Unfortunate thing for Team Canada, they just finished a power play. Ray Bourque had been on the ice for the full 2 minutes of the power play. Suddenly, he is checked by Makarov. The puck pops free, and in goes Homotov unassisted to score. A big, big goal, and we'll see how big as this game unfolds. Somehow, I don't think this game is going to end up with a 4-2 final score. There's the way it has been in Canada Cup since the beginning, way back in 1976. In 76, of course, Canada played the Soviet Union only once, and that was in the preliminary round. Czechoslovakia played Canada in the final. 1981, there was a 7-3 victory in the preliminary round, but then in that final, a disastrous 8-1 victory for the Soviet Union. 1984, 6-3 Soviets in the preliminary round, but then Canada in that wonderful overtime game in the semifinal. And of course, here in 1987, dead even through three games, and now we're into the second period of the fourth game.
And immediately, Canada clear the puck into the Soviet zone. Makarov is there, number 24. Back he comes, trying to go around Patrick. Tipped away by Canada, and Fuhr away out of the net to clear that. Here's Patisov trying to hold it in. And again, it's Rochefort with a lead pass to Messier. Kostatonov and Messier. There's Messier trying to center, was tipped away, and Kostatonov gives it to Makarov, who speeds in on left wing. Patrick takes him out of the play. Gartner cleared it. Here's Kurutov centering back. Larionov to Patisov. Six save Fuhr on Patisov. Patisov still with it for the Soviets. Got it in front. Batted away by Rochefort. Now Patrick, number six from the New York Rangers. Leaving it for Rochefort. Up the middle to Gartner. Tipped in. And shot right back out by number 29, Kravchuk. Into center ice. Here's Kurutov moving in. Hartsburg dives to break it up. Now drops back, and Kravchuk is checked by Krop. Gretzky breaks away with Tocchet. Two on one. Gretzky to Tocchet. Feigned on it from about 20 feet out. Now Krop after the loose puck. And it's Homotov breaking out of there. Homotov, number 15, bumped off the puck. Krop drops it back. Coffey clearing one. And Kravchuk goes back to try and clear it, and does. Bekov, now it's called on an offside at the Soviet blue line, and that's the way the second period begins.
There's Paul Coffey, been very strong throughout this tournament. Again, his speed is so much a part of his game. He's a two-time Norris Trophy winner. Quite often he is paired with fellows who have controlled the Norris Trophy the last 3 years. Of course, Ray Bourque won it in 1987.
Canada down by 4-2. Coffey living it for Greg Hartsburg. Lifted it to center. Prop is checked. Now Coffey picks it up. Canada playing catch up. Coffey to Gretzky, knocked away from him. And here's Samak feeding one to Bekov. Moves in. Shoots. Fuhr just got his glove on it. Rebound. Bekov a shot. Fuhr stops that and cleared it away. And Tocchet feeds Gretzky. That's knocked away. Kamienski now for the Soviets, firing it back in. Coffey back to pick it up. Paul Coffey leads a four-man Canada rush. Fedotov there to clear it. Coffey holding his ground on the boards against Fedotov. Gretzky comes in to try and pry it loose, and finally it's held for a faceoff. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
There's no sign of life, it's just a part of charm. I'm lying in the rain. Oh, I try. Whoa! Never gonna go for Canada. What's the country about? Now I know the choice is mine. Falling in love
interesting strategy here by Mike Keenan. Looks like the second period begins. He's split up Gretzky and Lemieux. And Lemieux is now up there with Sutter and Gulick. Semyonov against Lemieux on the faceoff. And the Soviets break out of there. Womackin number 23 against Bork. Bork rides him out of the play. Bork clearing it up to Michel Gulick. Shot to center, Gusarov over to Podotov. Out of Semyonov, number 30. Fires it in. Zamak in after it. Zamak to Lomakin. Shot off a skate wide. Here's Semyonov. He's checked, and here's Lemieux. Has Goulet and Sutter with him. Broken up, Sutter the trailer, centered it, but shot away by Gusarov for the Soviets. Pure scooping it up on the boards to Murphy. Murphy shot at the center, but Petisov intercepts there and gives it to number 8, Kubalev. At center now to Petisov, upended by Bork on the play. Priyakin into the corner, but Petisov cleared it around. Toss a tone off to Priyakin. Brent Sutter ties him up, and Larry Murphy has it. He gives it to Bork. Back on the wing, Sutter shot at the center. Intercepted by Priyakin. Bork trying to ride him up. Priyakin and Bork now. Nemchinov knocked down back to the net by Howard Chuck. Here's Kovalev trying to center. Nemchinov to Priyakin. And he skated off, and Gretzky trying to chip it up. Soviets hold it in. Here comes Gretzky. Neat move, Gretzky. Looking to make a play. Gretzky still with it. Checked from behind by Kovalev, who was able to shoot it out of there. And going back is Hartsburg. To Coffey, into center ice to Gilmore, but Kurutov intercepts. He drops it back to Kasatonov. Fired up the middle, and here is Larionov. Hartsburg breaks that up. Beating Anderson to Messier. Back to Anderson, Kasatonov cleared it. Messier to Anderson. Back on the boards, Kurutov. As Larionov and Makarov with him, a three-on-three break. Pass to Makarov, flipped in front. Kurutov was there, but couldn't make the deflection. Anderson for Canada. Got it outside the line, carried back in offside by the Soviets. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
You've heard about those 5, 6, 7 year warranties, but do you know where their coverage really ends? Right here, powertrain only. The Mazda Leadership Warranty is bumper to bumper for 3 years or 80,000 kilometers, and all major components for 5 years or 100,000 kilometers. The 1988 Mazda Leadership Warranty, the best in the business.
Gardner's assignment is Sergei Makarov. Now take a look at this little play with the knee. Now Makarov got up and made a play right after that, but he took him out of the play long enough that he wasn't clear when he got up. He wound up with the puck, got the puck wide of the net.
Now Lemieux out there with Prop and Tocket for Canada. Here's Rochefort flipping it into center ice, and the newcomer Kropchuk is there to shoot it back up. Now controlled by Stelnov, number 4. Ahead onto the wing. Here's Kamienski moving in, trying to center to Homotop. Broken up, and Canada's Crossman cleared it. Prop sliding it all the way down the ice. And it's grabbed by Milnikov. As then Stelnov and Lemieux bump into each other after the whistle.
Well, Coffey, who had his problems over a period of time with his skates, adjusting them once again. 4-2, the Soviets leading Canada. This is more his shin guard than his skates. Last year, he had a dreadful time. It was through the first part of the season. Just couldn't find a pair of skates that fit him properly. He's in a slump. Got over that, and of course, finished strongly and led the team to a Stanley Cup.
Now Canada with a forward line of Howard Chuck, Goulet, and James Patrick up front, normally a defenseman. Rochefort and Crossman on defense. Howard Chuck gets the draw. Shot by Rochefort, deflects just wide. Belichick took no chance as it came off the backboards and just smothered it.
Well, one thing when you've got a defenseman up on your forward line in a faceoff in the offensive zone, he's the kind of guy who can go right into that goal mouth area. He's used to the traffic in there, and he has to face that kind of traffic defending his own zone. There's a young player who's shown a lot of promise in this tournament, Anatoly Fedotov. He'll be around for a long time, plays for Moscow Dynamo.
He's 21 years of age. Tikhanov is intense. Here's a drive by Canada. Rossbauer let it go. Milnikov making the stop back of the net. Gusarov trying to clear it out of there. And it's carried out by Lomakin, number 23. Crossman checked in. Now Fedotov wide with that shot. And Rossbauer takes Homotov out of the play with a tough check. Canada can't get it out. Semyonov holding it in. Well wide with that shot. Now cleared in by Fedotov, and Rossbauer has it for Canada. Rossbauer up the middle to Howardchuk. He's upended, and he's hurt as Gusarov caught him right at center ice. And Howardchuk is shaken up. And now Gusarov goes down. I didn't see what happened to him. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
For a limited time, McDonald's presents Double Features.
It's back.
But it's not alone.
The return of the famous McDonald's Double Hamburger. A masterpiece for only $1.19. And the famous McDonald's Double Cheeseburger. It's back for a return engagement. Unforgettable. Two all-beef patties. Melted processed cheese. A sensation for only $1.39. McDonald's Double Features. An incredible taste, an incredible deal. Just till October 12th.
Dale Howardchuk very upset at the hit he took from Gusarov in the center ice zone. Then Gusarov was nailed by Rossbauer afterwards as a retaliatory measure. Koharski didn't see that. He was looking at the original incident, and this is why Fetisov is arguing. Watch to the left of your screen here. You'll see in the center ice zone, Howardchuk is kneed perhaps by Gusarov. And as Gusarov went down to defend in his own zone, he was nailed by Rossbauer and went down himself. There's Gusarov, another good young defenseman of this team, 23 years of age.
No penalties on either play. Soviets 4, Canada 2. Soviets led 3-1 after the first period of game 1. Made it 4-1. Canada came back eventually to tie it. Game 2. Canada led 3-1 after one, and the Soviets came back to tie it. The two goals with these teams, differential after one period, not proving to be that much. Here's Hartzler decking Himelak with a check as he caught him with his head down. Now Priyakin racing in. Canada starting to throw their weight around, and it's shot out by Tocchet down the ice. Konstantinov going back together. And it's icing called against Canada.
Wow, a couple of great hits. Hartsburg was the one that started it. And Hartsburg in a foul mood with the scoreboard reading 4-2. Somebody said something to him, but a good clean hit in the center ice zone. And then a couple of hits down in the Team Canada zone. Here it comes right to your screen. He nailed him, stood him straight up, sat him straight down. And they're going to have to do a little more of that. Looks like they're getting a little mad, and I think probably that's maybe the best thing that could happen to Team Canada. They played the first period a little less than the total enthusiasm.
Hit, but they better stay out of the penalty
box. That's right. Keep them clean. Keep the sticks down.
Here's Crossman for Canada to Gartner. He couldn't get it out. Kurutov has it for the Soviets. Over to Makarov. Rockport bumps him hard. And Canada then clear it out of there. Anderson sliding at the center ice. Now Fetisov passing it up on the wing to Kurutov. Rossbauer back together. Messier, Anderson, and Gartner up front. Here's Messier leaving it for Anderson. He's checked, and Makarov breaks away with only Rossbauer back. He has Kurutov with him to Kurutov. Shoots, hold, cure.
just got a piece of that, and it trickled off to the corner. And Crossman has it for Canada. Gelno pinching in. Now Messier. Messier loses. Makarov trying to carry back in. Crossman tying it up. And a jam up in the corner. Rossport coming up with it. Flips it up. It hits Makarov as he was going to the bench. Now Crossman cleared once. Gelno jammed in there by Anderson. And it's held. And we get a stoppage in play. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
I got you. I know I got you.
You got 88 Toyota trucks coming in.
And 87s are still here.
So I'll take this Toyota off your hands if...
You give me a real deal.
Yeah, make me a deal right now.
Because I don't have much time.
And you don't either.
Take advantage of your Toyota dealer right now, because he's got to move the 87s awfully fast, and that can mean the best deals of the year.
Hey, I know I got you.
So get them while they still got them.
On the right there is Larionov. On the left was Kurutov, but it's Makarov who paved the way for this play. And the shot by Kurutov just trickled through and behind. Boy, they have been dangerous, especially in this game. Dan Makarov, he is having a great hockey game. When they get a scoring chance, it's a dandy. They seem to be wide open. And that's where the shots on goal don't mean very much. But chances are good. Bekov flipping it in. Fuhr there to clear it. Lemieux couldn't get it. Gelno held it in. Warren blocked his shot. Lifts it up the middle. And it's shot back in by the Soviets. Now Lemieux and Gretzky are out on the forward line, back together with Kropp, the other member of that trio. Here comes Murphy into Lemieux. Lemieux cutting in. Lemieux trying to center. Does to Bork. Bork got it in front. Gretzky in front. And Lemieux was upended. And there'll be a penalty to Bekov, as he tripped Lemieux at the side of the net. And a Canada power play coming right up. Bekov to the penalty box. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Your Texaco retailer isn't faster than a speeding bullet. He can't leap tall buildings in a single bound. And he's slightly less powerful than a locomotive. But when you need service, he's there. Besides, he's a super guy. Expect more from Texaco.
Will that be all?
You got a phone booth around here?
Vyacheslav Bekov goes off for tripping Mario Lemieux. A great chance here. Watch Gretzky. Here is the puck rolling loose. Gretzky gets a little bit of a piece of it, rolls it. I don't know how he got that pass away, and then Bekov just nailed Lemieux in the goal mouth area, and that drew the tripping penalty. It's the second time that Lemieux has drawn a penalty in this game. As he drawn a penalty, his Czech has taken a penalty trying to handle him. But 8:24, Canada goes on the power play, and the crowd here is starting to pick it up once again. Gretzky up front with Lemieux and Tockett. Murphy and Bork will be the point men. Canada 1-for-3 on the power play tonight. Trailing 4-2, but with a chance here. And now Gretzky. Wanted to talk to someone, I believe. Somebody's showing the linesman that something's on the ice.
And now he's going to go over and discuss things while the linesmen are busy. With Mike Keenan. One thing you can do is just kind of... here are the scoring leaders up to date in the tournament. Gretzky, 3 points ahead of Lemieux. Makarov, having a big night tonight, is close to within a point of Lemieux. And Kurutov with 14 points now. Nicely balanced, 7 goals and 7 assists.
Here's Messier to, or at least Gretzky to Tockett. Couldn't get a stick on it. Gretzky again. Tries to center. Lemieux was open but fanned on it. And the Soviets come back, led by Lomaka. 2-on-2 break. Murphy there to use the poke check. And ties up Lomaka. And Lomaka trying to freeze it. Murphy gets it loose. Larry Murphy. Fires it in. Gretzky comes in. It comes to Murphy. Back to Bork. Into Lemieux.
Soviets go into that box. They drop it to Bork, a drive, and a save by Milnikov. And he held it.
Big thing about this line, the way they've got it now with Lemieux and Gretzky, they've added Tocchet to the line. And Tockett's the man. He's the designated slot man. He's in there to cause problems for Milnikov. Good play here, and this is the difference. They're getting the shot away now with Tocchet right in front of the net. Gretzky swooping in, looking for any kind of a rebound himself. He's a very important guy in this game so far, Rick Tocchet. He's played a lot of roles, but most of them are the physical roles. And he's been very much responsible for the two goals that Canada has. Points on both of them.
Tocchet from Scarborough, Ontario, a key member of the Philadelphia Flyers. 1:20 left in the penalty. Now Gretzky over to question the referee Koharski about something. Soviets, Ron, to me, tonight when they're shorthanded, are playing the box and not playing as aggressively in a shorthanded situation as they did earlier.
They don't want to let them get too much of that game in close.
Here's Bork for Canada. Into Lemieux. Back to Bork. Over onto the wing to Murphy, centered. Tipped away by Makarov. Lemieux, back of the net to Gretzky. In front to Murphy, shoots, he scores! He'll play with it, shoot it! What happened was the defense got spread out here. Tocchet, they started to worry about Tocchet at the side of the net. Murphy wound up getting the puck at the side. As the defense was going the wrong way on the short side, he put it in. But whether that shot had been blocked or not, it certainly paved the way for a good rebound. And as it was, it found the hole. And Canada trails by just a goal. Another great setup by Gretzky as Murphy gets his first of the Canada Cup. Comes with 10:40 left in the second period.
The other point goes to Mario Lemieux.
So Gretzky and Lemieux get the assist. Canada within one of the Soviets. Here's Priyakin coming in. Coffey trying to take him out. Back to get it. This Tocchet feeds it to Gretzky. Delnov in to tie him up. And now Gretzky gets it to Coffey. Out for Tocchet, but intercepted and shot back in by the Soviets. Coffey back for Canada. Coffey being checked by Priyakin, and Priyakin dumps it in. And now Propp has to go back for Canada. Out on left wing to Gretzky. Over for Hartsburg, off the board for Propp. Brian Propp, number 26, shooting it in. Going back to get it, Propp checked. Gretzky stole it, centered, Kaminsky intercepts. Soviets come back. Number 13, Kaminsky. Let's it go, and that's high off the glass. Right back the other way, Canada with Gretzky. The copy to Propp has Sutter with him. Here's the shot, high and over the glove of Milnikov. Propp behind the net, trying to get up to Sutter. Brent Sutter for Canada. Bekov comes up with it. Now to Holmatov. Holmatov got it to the line. Rossbor held it in, and Gusarov has it for the Soviets. To Holmatov, number 15. Flipped in, cleared out by Krossman. Now Fedotov trying to set up Kaminsky. Back comes Krossman for Canada, trying to beat it up to Goulet. Goulet on the left wing board. Slides it around. Into the corner goes Krossman. Now to Howardchuk. Dale Howardchuk, center to shot. They score! Brent Sutter ties this game up!
The key to this is look at the traffic in front of the net. Out comes the pass. Everybody going for the net, and Sutter with a great shot off the roof. Howardchuk is getting it out in front. Sutter moving in. Glove side. Couldn't put it in a better spot.
Canada comes back to tie it at 4-4. The Soviets at one time led 3-0.
Howard
Chuck and Crossman will draw assists on this. Here's Howard Chuck out in front. Again, that great shot. The feeling is glove side high on Milnikov. You can beat him. He doesn't have a good glove hand.
Brent Sutter's first goal of the tournament. Howard Chuck and Crossman the assist. 11:06 the time. Canada 4, the Soviets 4.
Oh, the crowd's starting to take over, too. You can hear them start to build with the Murphy goal. Now they're really going. We've got the coach up on top of the bench.
Wow. Something has been thrown onto the ice, and that's where, why we're having a delay is one of the rink attendant, and he's out to scrape something that's been thrown onto the ice. That gives Milnikov a chance to get a breather.
Get another look at the goal by Sutter. And again, we talk about the problem that Milnikov has with his glove hand. Howard Chuck handling it from behind the net, feeds it out in front. And the slow glove. Now, that's a tough shot for anybody to deal with. I don't care, but right now, it put Canada into a 4-4 tie. We'll take a break right now as they clean things up on the ice. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Labatt's Blue presents Thirst for First. Highlights of the Blue Jays in flight.
To win a pennant, you've got to win the extra inning games. Here we are, bottom of the 11th inning against Seattle. Two down, bases loaded, upshot to plate. There's a drive to deep left field. It's off the wall. The Jays win it 3-2 and take another step closer to the pennant.
The Blue Jays' Thirst for First game highlights brought to you by Labatt's Blue. When you've got a thirst for first, it's time to call for the Blue.
Canada 4, the Soviets 4, and here we go with 4, flipping it in for Canada. Racing in was Sutter, but it was whistled down on an offside or a high sticking call, I believe, ruling that the Soviets had knocked the puck down with a high stick.
Canada with a 7-4 shots on goal edge in this period, but again, the shots on goal, as Dan mentioned, not a good statistic in this particular game because the Soviets have had so many good scoring, clean scoring chances. They scored 3 goals on their first 4 shots, and each of them was a good, clean scoring chance.
Now Gilmore, Lemieux, and Sutter, the Canada forward line. Breaking out is Lomachin for the Soviets. Poked back by Bork and Lemieux. Right back for Canada. Mario Lemieux trying to leave it there. Knocked down and Semyonov. Right back the other way for the Soviets. Lemieux gets up limping. Now Gilmore back of the goal. Gilmore trying to clear it out, and now we're going to get a penalty. Back of the play is Lemieux and Kasatonov. We're making threatening glances at each other.
All right, here's the play. Now there's a slash in here, but watch the skate of Kasatonov. And there's the slash across the back of the leg. But I don't think Lemieux appreciated that skate very much. It may have been inadvertent, but it certainly was an area where it could have caused a lot of damage.
So the Soviets in this 4-4 game with a man advantage. Slashing against Lemieux. 8:26 left in the second period. Soviets are 0-for-1 with the man advantage tonight. They send out the green unit. Larionov, Makarov, and Kurutov with Batisov and Kasatonov on defense. Canada with Messier and Gartner up front. Soviets with the man advantage. Rossport from the faceoff. Tries to clear it out. Pinching in. Batisov to Larionov. Larionov to Makarov. Kicks it to Kurutov and Rossport checks in. Kasatonov held it in. Over onto the board to Larionov. Back to Kasatonov. Return to Larionov. Now to Batisov. Shooting. Blocked by Gartner. Batisov to Kurutov and Gartner breaks it up again. And then cleared it to center up.
Couple of key plays defensively by Mike Gardner. Here's Caruta. To Fatita. Now to Lariana. Lariana flips it in. Caruta cuts in. Big save, pure rebound. And that's chopped away by Crossman for Canada. Lariana held it in. His shot blocked by Messier, and Rossport shoots it away. And a minute left in the penalty, and an interference call as Gardner gets upended. And an interference call coming up here to the Soviets. And to Lariana.
Watch the left-hand side of the screen on the replay, and you'll see Gardner, number 12 for Canada, knocked down right in the center ice zone as the puck was cleared up ice. Lariana. That means that Canada, at the end of the Lemieux penalty, will have a minute and 2 seconds, barring further penalties. They'll have a minute and 2 seconds of power play. Here's Krutoff. Every time you see these guys, you got to get up on the edge of your seat. What a save that was. And then Kasatonov moving quickly in for the rebound, but he was forced into the corner.
Krutoff scored a goal in game two in a very similar situation.
He came a man short, copied Anderson, deflected it. Nolnikov made the save
and then smothers it. 53 seconds left in Lemieux's penalty, 156 left in Larionov's penalty for the Soviets.
What a deflection there by Anderson, taking that shot from the point by Coffey, and it, all he did was get the heel of his stick on it and steer it right into the padding of Nolnikov.
Gretzky getting Coffey positioned properly. Gretzky against Bekov on the faceoff. Gretzky gets it into the corner. Gets help from Anderson. Now Stelno over. And he gets help from Bekov, who feeds it off to Homotov, number 15. Coffey spun him around. Goharski looks the other way as he figures Homotov took a dive.
And he did.
Hartford shooting it in.
And he did.
Back to get it, number 29, Igor Kravchuk, up to Bekov. Bekov trying to get around Hartford. Bekov to Homotov. And Canada come back. Here's Gretzky. Gretzky trying to get Coffey going the other way. Now a break for the Soviets. 2-on-1. Bekov to Humalap, and a stick save by Buehr on the 2-on-1. Now Lemieux back on. Another shot by the Soviets. Buehr the save, and here's Lemieux. With Gretzky, 2-on-1 break. Big save, Milnikov on Gretzky. And that time it was Lemieux putting in number 99. And Milnikov split across to make the save. Canada on a power play. 35 seconds left in the Soviets' penalty. Now Semyonov firing it in. Back to get it is Gort for Canada. Ramo Bork flips it in. Fatisov back after it. That's pocket into Korchuk. Here's Gretzky. Center, Lemieux in front. Couldn't get the shot off. Gretzky again. To Bork. Over to Murphy. Into Gretzky. Back to Bork. Into Lemieux. Across to Murphy. Shooting. Blocked at the defense on a dive across by Fatisov.
Oh, they moved it around again and around and around, and they did set up a play. But a defenseman was the one who took the shot. Fatisov making the save on Murphy. Very nicely set up. There's Rick talking. Big check inside the zone started this. That's Lemieux. Across. Here's Murphy. And the shot blocked by Fatisov, who was down with plenty of time to block that shot. Had it been a Gretzky or a Lemieux, you might have seen a quicker trigger. Now Arianov
is out of the penalty box, so the Soviets are at full strength. 5:23 left in the second period. Canada 4, Soviets 4. Here's Messier on a faceoff. gets it to Gartner. He and Kutisov battle. And now Krutov to Makarov. Back to Krutov. Upended, and Crossman is there for Canada. Trying to clear it up. Makarov held it in. Over to Konstantinov. His shot blocked. Messier couldn't get it up. Here's Makarov. Back on the point to Kutisov. Centers to Krutov. Shot right on, and pure. Made the save and held on. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Ladies and gentlemen, a reminder that...
Don't back up. Now you hit the guy behind you.
Some days, it's hard to share the fantasy, isn't it? Ah, well, thank goodness some things never change. Like the great taste of milk. Fresh, cold, and delicious. Which is why we say the more tangled life gets, the more sense milk makes.
Well, we have had a few dives in this game. Here is one of them. This is the one we mentioned. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Greg Louganis.
On the top was the player who Boharski just looked at him and looked the other way.
I'll tell you something. Both sides are doing a fair amount of that tonight.
Soviet Kutisov at the point for the faceoff. Closing in. Murphy dives to poke it away. Now Makarov. Back of the net. Gets it back from Kutisov. Makarov for Krutov. He's checked. Canada clear it. Soviets hold it in, but now carried up by Murphy. Has Howard Chuck and Sutter with him. To Howard Chuck. Shoot. He'll look out the save. Howard Chuck back of the net. Stops it in front. Shoot. He scores! Dale Howard Chuck!
There's an old line, Dan, that says when you hit a guy, you create a turnover. Sutter behind the net was the reason for this play. Here comes the puck into the zone. The shot is going to go off the goaltender, Melnikov. Here comes Sutter. He's going to take the puck away. Creates the turnover. Howardchuk, one chance. Comes back out to him. Second shot into the net. And Canada, for the first time, has the lead. His fourth goal of the tournament, Dale Howardchuk. But the key again was the slugging along the board. It's almost like we're watching that big Soviet game in 1984. The sluggers are doing the job at the key time. Tocchet, Sutter. Take a look at the names that are cropping up on the score sheet here tonight. Look at the turnover. Here it comes. There's the big check. And the puck is turned over.
The scoring play, Howardchuk from Murphy and Kropp, 15-32 the time.
Sutter does not get a point, but I'll tell you, that guy right there loves him.
Dale Howardchuk from the Winnipeg Jets has just given Canada the lead for the first time tonight.
Amazing. We've seen so much of Lemieux and Gretzky, and suddenly in a big game like this one, the Grinders are out.
Now a Team Canada line of Gilmore, Tocchet, and Goulet. 4:28 left in the second period. 5-4 Canada.
Isn't it amazing the difference in this hockey game compared to games one and two of this series? The artistry isn't there. The excitement certainly is.
And a lot of thumping in this game, more than in games one and two. Bork back after to get the puck for Canada. Passing it to Murphy. Murphy to Gilmore. Too far for him. Gilmore racing in. Shot her out of the board. Here's Tocchet. Back of the net. But intercepted by Krawchuk and cleared. And the Soviets work it to Homotov at center ice. Bork took him out of the play. And Gilmore knocked it to Goulet. And now a high sticking penalty coming up to Bork as he took Homotov out of the play. And Canada. Canada will be shorthanded as Bork goes to the penalty box.
Alan Eagleton is going to be our guest during the second intermission if he can get his nerves settled down. Oh, that's an NHL referee there you're yelling at. Al? Don Koharski calling him as he sees him, and he has seen Ray Bork high stick somebody. And he has called him for it. I wouldn't change a thing the way Team Canada is playing right now. They're getting the odd penalty, but they're also playing the type of hockey that when things have gone sour in the overall playmaking of Gretzky and Lemieux is going to win for them.
Soviets on a power play with a forward line of Semyonov, Womackin, and Semak. White men will be Gusarov and Fedotov. Canada with Gilmore up to win the faceoff. He and Anderson are the penalty killers with Crofton and Rossbourg on defense. Gilmore broke the play up. Now Gusarov dropping it back to Fedotov. To Gusarov. Alexei Gusarov up the middle for Semyonov, number 30. Semak centered and Anderson there to tip it away. And then Gilmore cleared it away for Canada. Fedotov, number 14 for the Soviets, a minute 30 left in Canada's penalty. Now Gusarov to Fedotov. Back to Gusarov. Firing to Semyonov, into Lomakin, dropped it to Semak, but Gartner intercepts. And Gartner fires it away.
Notice how they're picking up the men right at the line. Something Brad brought up there, letting the defense back in. They're not doing it anymore.
Here's Larionov as the Soviets change on the fly, leaving it for Gusarov. Now to Makarov. Gartner checked him. Makarov tries again to Krutov. Krutov leaving it for Larionov. He drops it back, and Kapisov couldn't hold it in. 42 seconds left in the penalty. Fedotov to Kasatonov. Kasatonov, number 7. Leaving it for Krutov over to Makarov. Now to Fedotov. Into Larionov. To Fedotov to Kasatonov. Moves in deeper, and Murphy took it away from him, and Murphy clears it out of there. 12 seconds left in the penalty. Excellent penalty killing here by Canada. Larionov now trying. Leaves it for Fedotov. Fedotov flipping it in. Rostin there to poke it away. Gretzky flips it. Anderson able to carry it out. And Gretzky now takes the pass at center ice. Breaking in with Bork. Gretzky shoots one. And that one off a stick high and wide. And back the other way. Makarov. Teams at full strength now. As Bork has served his penalty. Here's Brian Propp. Fans on it as he went to clear it. Now drops it to Rochefort. Over to Crossman. Off the boards to Gretzky. Gretzky dumps it in. But he's not there for the Soviets. Now cleared out of there by Semyonov. And Kumalev flips it ahead for Priyakin. He gets knocked out by Bork. And Bork will get another penalty here. With 1:09 left in the period, a hooking call against Bork.
The Labatt player of the game for the Soviet Union will receive a set of 10 Olympic coins, compliments of Canadian Tire, an official supplier to the Calgary 1988 Olympic Winter Games, and a few dreams along the way. Canadian Tire.
Mario Lemieux arguing about the penalty call, but it's a hooking penalty against Bork.
Well, Ray Bork up against the boards. In this case, I'd give the penalty. He may have put a little mustard on it, but he also got hooked. Last time, Bork was off. No shots on goal by the Soviets, so they did a terrific job on the penalty killing last time out, but you can play with fire, too. You ought to keep doing this.
Just a minute 9 left in the period, so Canada will, if they can get through this first part, the first minute 9, will have a break in the intermission to rest up their penalty killers. Soviets are 0-for-3 tonight with the man advantage.
And the penalty killers, who did a pretty good job last time for the most part. Gartner out there. And Rochefort will be back at the blue line.
Doug Gilmore is going to take the faceoff against Becca,
who's shown us some pretty good skills in terms of faceoffs this tournament.
Soviets have four men inside the blue line. Homotop is away off on the right wing board, but Gilmore wins the draw, and the Soviets have to go back and regroup. Here, Propchuk, number 29, giving it to number 15, Homotop. We're in the final minute of period one. Kamienski moving in. Gartner takes him out. Fuhr out of the net to clear it. Homotop losing it. Gilmore trying to knock it out of there and did, with a volleyball type move, hitting it with his hand, and he hit it up into the Soviets bench. So the faceoff will be back inside the blue line.
Off the Soviet player's head, I think. And so the faceoff will come back inside the Team Canada zone. There's Gilmore. There's some of the players that have really noticeably improved their game as the finals have come on. Gilmore and Brian Propp is very interesting. The overtime period the other night and this game, playing very, very well.
Now Messier comes out to replace Gartner, so Messier and Gilmore will be the penalty killers. Now Gartner comes back. And they're going to take Gilmore out of there and leave Gartner and Messier up front.
This is a Team Canada home game, by the way. They have the last change, or whatever it's worth.
Beckhoff against Messier, 47 seconds left in the period. Soviets on a power play. And they get it to Stelnov, who moves in from the point. Shot it around, Homotop. Right at center one, Gartner there to clear it away. Propchuk, number 29, back to pick it up. Propchuk was supposed to be out for this series with a knee ligament problem, but he's in there tonight. He feeds it to Kamienski. Into Homotop. Rochefort ties him up. Homotop gets loose. Gartner hacks away on him. Now back off to Propchuk. Shot right on. Kamienski after the rebound. Propchuk a drive, and that's just wide. And Messier, with 8 seconds left, clears it out of there. Soviets have to go back. Propchuk, with 2 seconds left, clears it up. Second period is over. A good one for Canada as they come off the ropes and take the lead after 40 minutes.
Well, they outscored the Soviets in the second period, 3-0. And they have the lead, 5-4. Canada outshot the Soviets, 12. The Soviets outshot Canada, 12-8 in the second period. Just the turnaround of the last period. Canada outscored the Soviets, 3-0.
We've seen that a time or two before in this series. 5-4, Canada leads after two. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Find out how a test drive of a Volkswagen Jetta can lead to a flight on the British Airways Concorde to Europe to pick up your prize of a brand new Jetta.
He was in that little room of his off the dressing room, I'm sure trying to concoct a couple of others that will be right for certain situations.
First 52 seconds of this period will be pivotal, because Canada and Ray Bourque will be in the penalty box as the Soviets in this rubber game, the third and deciding game for the 1987 edition of the Canada Cup, starts to unfold in period three before us.
There's something said up here after the first period. He said if it had been anybody but Grant Fuhr, he likely would have been taken out of the game. And I think probably they're right. Grant Fuhr is the kind of goaltender who can be cold in a segment of a game and then suddenly just be brilliant. And I thought he made a couple of very, very important stops in the second period. If he did not have a good first period, you'll be the first to admit it. Ray Bourque in the penalty box, off for hooking at 18:51 of that second period. The shots on goal overall, Canada 27, the Soviets 21.
So not as big a differential as we talked about earlier, 27-21 in favor of Canada.
That's because the Soviets outshot Canada 12-8 while being outscored 3-0.
Here we go at the third period. Hold on to your hat. Canada clear it out as Crossman shot it up on the boards, and it goes over the glass into the penalty box area.
Nearly decapitated Bork sitting there.
Faceoff will be about 10 feet inside the Team Canada blue line. Messier and Gertner up front, Rochefort and Crossman on defense. The green unit for the Soviets. Zarutov, Makarov, and Larionov up front. Batisov and Kasatonov, the point men.
How'd you like the job, Dan, of selecting the outstanding player for Canada in this game?
Or in this tournament. Puck cleared down the ice. Kasatonov back to pick it up. Soviets with the man advantage. Up the middle to Kurutov, now to Larionov. Leaves for Makarov. Makarov poked back by Crossman, and then Gertner got it to the line, but not out. Now Messier does knock it out of there. And Kasatonov with 20 seconds left in the penalty. Over to Larionov. Leaving for Kasatonov. Crossman picks it off and cleared it out. Batisov to Larionov. 5 seconds left in the penalty. Larionov firing it around. Now Bork is back on. Here's Batisov, and a poor pass has to be covered up on by Kasatonov, who gives it to Larionov. Larionov to Makarov. He cuts in. Now around Coffey. Got it in front. Fewer the save. Still loose. Back at it. Just wide of the net. And Gretzky is back to get it for Canada. Look at Gretzky carry out. Hook check by Gruta. Covering up on the play is Murphy. Murphy into Lemieux. Offside at the Soviet blue line. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
This is what it's like to be a fan in Hamilton, cheering Team Canada on to what they hope will be a victory.
Howard, Chuck, Goulet, and Tocchet for Canada. Bork and Murphy on defense. Dumped in by Canada. Howard, Chuck into the corner. Gets help from Tocchet to Howard, Chuck to Goulet, but he couldn't handle a pass. And back comes Kolmatov, number 15, with Bekov, and it's broken up by Murphy and cleared away. Number 29, Igor Kropchuk, back after it. He quickly fired it up. Goulet carried back in with a couple of teammates already in the Soviet zone, and it's called in an offside.
Now, Michel Goulet of the Quebec Nordiques, assistant 50-goal scorer in the National Hockey League. And he'll be out there playing on a line with Gilmore and Sutter at this particular time, and now they call him up. We're going to try a new combination that has Howardchuk out there.
Semyonov on the faceoff against Sutter. Canada taking it. Now Murphy carries it. Firing it in. Gusarov back to get it. The same act, number 18. He just tipped it ahead to Semyonov. Howardchuk checks him. And Murphy firing it across to Bork. Bork for Canada. Dumping it in. Podolkov there with Howardchuk into second. Now Stamak back together. And Pocket ran into Gusarov and knocked him for a loop. Soviets clear it out of there. Trying to rule that Canada could have played it. There's no icing. Bork back after it. Bork to Gretzky. Leaving it for Bork. Up to Tocchet. Into center ice to Brent Sutter, who fired it in. Novikov making a save, and Gusarov back to get him. Leaves it there for Batisov. Loses to Lemieux to Gretzky. Here's Gretzky. Out in front, backhander. That hit Lemieux. Prop after the puck. Now Gretzky. Centered. Here's Coffey in.
Gretzky and Lemieux. Rhythm. Leaving for Gretzky. Gretzky across to Murphy. Shot it just wide. And Murphy came in aggressively from the point. Now it's Hartsburg. Into Brian Brock. Up high off the glass to Zetrov. Canada changing on the fly. Here's a clearing pass to Gretzky. And they whistle that down and offside at the Soviet blue line. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
I wonder how he's been lately. How's he getting along? Is he making his way? What's he doing today? Is he still working hard? Is he still keeping slim? Is he counting the days since I last called him?
When you're wondering how they're doing, that's what Bell Long Distance is for.
Seeming to play with a lot more confidence here in the third period. More in control of things, but that's the kind of thing that happens. There's a great play to copy from Gretzky. And a pretty good play by the goaltender. Milnikov stuck right with him.
Sergei Milnikov, his team trailing 5-4. And he may have held them in there with that save. Puck shot in by Canada. Anderson in on the boards. Comes to the point, into the corner to Gartner. Gartner trying to get it to Anderson. Knocked away by Kravchuk, and he carries the center. Igor Kravchuk, number 29. Cuts in, shot blocked, rebound. Putov put it over top of the net. Here's Anderson. He loses to Makarov. Center to Larionov. Rochefort blocked the shot. And the rebound is poked wide. Crossman for Canada. Rutop standing right in front of the net, keeping an eye on him, but Crossman beats Gartner, and Gartner slides the puck into the Soviet zone. Delnov, number 4, back to get it. Ahead to Larionov, into Kamienski, but broken up by Bork and shot to center, and Patrick tips it into the Soviet zone. Husarov back after it. Cleared it, knocked down by Murphy. And now the Soviets. With Fedota, Gilmore checked in. Gilmore giving it to Patrick. Now ahead to Goulet. Goulet against Kasarov, and he whips the shot high. Up into the crowd.
Four minutes, 53 seconds gone. There's Valery Kamienski. He was great at rendezvous. He scored only 13 goals in 37 games in the Soviet Union last year. But he made his year in Quebec City in the second game of rendezvous when he scored those very two important goals and then that great goal to tie up the game the other night against Team Canada. Sent it into overtime. He has just been a phenomenal player. Keep saying he's not strong enough, but he's got the great shot. As a matter of fact, I asked Grant Fuhr who the toughest shot to deal with on the team. He says Kamienski. Well, his teammates say the Kurutov's got the quickest release, the most dangerous shot, says Fuhr, is Kamienski.
Here are the Soviets. Semyonov, number 30, breaking down. Semyonov is checked, and Hartsburg chops the puck out of there. Soviets go back and get it. Kasatonov, number 7. To Lomakin. He leaves it. Gusarov to Samak. Now to Lomakin. Leaving it for Samak, right through his skates, and Rick Tocchet comes back for Canada. Tocchet jumping it in. It's all the way back out to center. Hartsburg waits for his team to get onside and drills it back in. Semyonov, number 30 for the Soviets. Gretzky into forecheck, gives it to Fetisov. Now to Kumalev, number 8. Gretzky checks into Lemieux. Lemieux over to Bork, who pinches in. Back of the net to Gretzky. Back to Bork, and Priyakin had it. Gretzky held it in to Murphy. Into Lemieux, shoots. Big save again by Milnikov. That time on Lemieux. Stolen center to Gretzky. Backhander shot it wide. Oh, Gretzky with a brilliant opportunity. Here's Imolat moving back. Long shot and sure shot back. Now Gretzky to Brian Brock. Kropp fires it in. Milnikov didn't appear to see it. Here's Gretzky. In behind the net. Chopped away by Nemchinov. Held in by Anderson to Gretzky behind the goal. Looking for Lemieux. Lemieux well covered. Gretzky will come out himself. Turn, shoot. Milnikov got a stick on it. Here's Anderson. They have Lemieux tied up and not at the side of the net. Here's Makarov. Tied up by Gretzky, but gets away. Now to Nemchinov, number 12. Leaves for Kurukov. Gretzky trying to steal it. Here's Kucherov firing it in. Crossman for Canada. Back he comes with Messier. Messier shoots from a bad angle. Milnikov to save. Bodies fly everywhere. And we got to stop it. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Only from Dodge. Two trucks for the price of one. Compact plus full size. It's the midsize Dodge Dakota. The fuel economy and sporty handling of a compact. The comfort, cargo space, and pulling power of a full size. Two trucks in one, plus 7115 warranty protection. Midsize Dakota from the Dodge family of Ram Top Trucks.
When the going gets tough, the tough is going.
People are always amazed at Wayne Gretzky's staying power. He just had a shift that lasted longer than 2 minutes. And yet at the tag end of it, he was still doing things. Just missed the net, and right there with Mario Lemieux. He was going to steer that in with his hand if he could have. That was up on edge. The reason Gretzky didn't get good wood on it or a good angle on it. But what a long shift he had, and yet at the end he still had the power and the stamina to make a good scoring play.
That was Gartner from the faceoff, but Milnikov stopped, and Bork beats Messier. Bekov tying him up. Messier beating Gartner. Pass behind Goulet. Homatov darts back, got it into the zone, still has it. Homatov to Gusarov. Poke check by Bork. Homatov to Kamienski. Bork takes him out. Umpure knocking it back to the net, and Murphy. Has it for Canada. He goes out the other way and gives it to Bork. And Bork flips it to center. Kudobin back after it. Gartner right on top of him. Gartner up checking aggressively. Here's Gusarov. Now to Kudobin. In comes Howardchuk. Kudobin beats Kamienski. Now to Bekov. Messier took him up. Howardchuk getting it in. Soviets. Bekov trying to work it free, and Lomachen drops it back. Gusarov under pressure as Canada coming in to try and forecheck and rush the Soviets, and it's been working. Here's Semyonov breaking up. Long shot, Fuhr a glove save on that. Clears it up for the boards. Canada with a flip pass to Sutter that hopped over his stick. Semyonov trying to come back and copy. Has it for Canada. Into center ice, here's Sutter to Tockett, and they whistle it down on a two-line offside pass. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Every 4 years, when athletes go off to represent their country, there is a pride shared by everyone. And while Olympic competition is a test to be met by the athlete alone, the opportunity to compete is a moment too precious not to be shared with those who matter most. That's why Labatt's is sending the parents of every Canadian Olympic athlete to the Winter Games in Calgary. Because after all, they should be there too.
Look at the point system or situation as far as this game is concerned. The top point man is Larry Murphy. He has a goal and two assists. Tockett with a goal and an assist. So has Kropp. And so has Sutter and Howardchuk. Not the names you would expect.
Here's Coffey for Canada. Canada leading 5-4. 11 minutes, 10 seconds left in regulation time. Here's Lemieux to Kropp behind the net. Kropp couldn't get it centered, and Kasatonov beating one out too far ahead for Humalev. Went back to Schwarzberg, and they waved the icing off to the Soviet linesman. Here's Humalev into the corner. Canada come up with it, and Kropp is able to chip it out of there. And Fetisov goes back. Canada making a wholesale change on the fly. Puck cleared out. Here's Larionov. Larionov moving in. Taken out of the play by Kostka. Makarov with the puck. He gets tied up. Now shot around on the boards. Crossman for Canada, able to scoop it out of there. And Makarov goes hustling back for the Soviets. Messier right on his tail. Two players collide. Here's Makarov to Kurutov. Now Makarov into the corner. Centered. And Messier chips it into center ice. Delno back after it for the Soviets. And Gusarov takes over. Over to Larionov. Larionov flipping it into center ice. The Crossman for Canada to Norman Rochefort. Now to Gartner. He just lets it go, and here comes Doug Gilmore for Canada. Leaves it for Gartner with a drive off the glass. Bork behind the net to Gartner. Gartner trying to center. Flips it into the corner for Gilmore. He and Fedotov battle for it. Soviets come up with it, and Gusarov cleared it into center ice. 9.5 minutes left in the third period. Here's Canada with Goulet putting himself offside as he carried it in behind him. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
The house is paid up. Kids are out of college. Things are fantastic.
So what's the problem?
Things are not so fantastic. A financial genius, I'm not.
Very few people are. But at New York Life, we have the resources to make the most of your resources. Specially tailored financial solutions that go well beyond life insurance. You've worked hard, and we're here to help make your plans a reality.
Thank you.
New York Life, a more thoughtful look at life.
The hardest thing in the world is to get off to a bad start and then try to get your game right. Doug Crossman has recovered beautifully after he had his early problems in this game. That's known as playing the man. And Larionov flattened on the play.
Here's Canada with a line of Gilmore, Lemieux, and Goulet. Canada with a 5-4 lead. 9:20 left in regulation time. That's off for the Soviets. To the line, but Bork breaks it up to Lemieux. Lemieux to Gilmore. Gilmore flipping it through. Fetisov back to get it. Now Fetisov can't get away from Lemieux. Here's Bekov trying. Stick handling neatly. Bekov moving it in. Broken up in the defense. And Goulet clears to Lemieux. Lemieux couldn't get around Fetisov. And now covering up for Canada. Bork to Goulet. Into Lemieux. Lemieux cutting in. Shoots one. Off the skate and just wide. Goulet to Lemieux. Lemieux back to Goulet. Goulet put it through the creek. Here's Lemieux. To Goulet. Sutter alone in front, but he couldn't get it to him. Now Sutter comes in. Canada forced a face-off in the Soviet zone. 8:32 left in regulation time. Now to Chef Goulet in deep forechecking. And Canada produced a flurry around the net. The game is being played for a good part down on the Soviet end. So the old adage, a good defense is a good offense. Canada, again, I can't stress how confidently Canada is playing here in the third period. They have outshot the Soviets here in the third period, 10-4. Now, Kravchuk and Sutter from the faceoff tie each other up. And we'll get another faceoff deep in the Soviet zone.
Brent Sutter in this game has a goal and an assist. By the way, if you're Gretzky Lemieux fans, each has a point, each an assist. They've not been as dominant in this game on the score sheet, although they've certainly had their opportunities and have handled the puck a lot.
Both Gretzky and Lemieux have missed great chances here in this third period. Here's Pocket knocking it off the board. Semyonov checked by Sutter. He kicks it back to Coffey, who cleared it to center. Now Lomakis. He's bumped off the puck by Howardchuk. Pocket to Howardchuk, who fires it in. Pocket chipping it into Sutter. Sutter and Semyonov battle for it. Look at Pocket drying behind the net to Sutter. Trying to get it in front. Lomakin is there. Now to Semyonov, number 30. Over to Samak.
moving in, trying to get up to Lomakis. Our Chuck had him tied up, now center to shut the score. Samak ties this game up with 7:39 left in regulation time. So what else is new? Samak getting a puck right in front of the net. Semyonov being tied up by Coffey, and they kind of a collision there as Howardchuk went with him. And the puck just rolled past Fjord. Samak closing in tight. Puck bouncing off the board. Everybody giving chase, and that little pick allowed the forward to skirt behind the net and slip it back out in front. And Samak has scored. He was the one who scored the game winner in overtime in game one of this series. So here we are, 7:39 left in regulation time, a 5-5 tie. Here is Gartner dropping it to Rochford, to Crossman. Back to Rochford. Into center ice off of Anderson's skate. Now Anderson shooting it in. And Fedotov goes back to pick it up. Fedotov trying to clear it. Anderson held it in. Demesiev shot away by the Soviets, and here comes number 8, Yuri Humalat, moving in, trying to go around Rochford. Humalat into the corner, Messier for Canada. Out to Mike Gartner. Gartner checked by Fedotov, gets it again, but then the play is offside at the Soviet blue line. 7:03 left in regulation. This is the Labatt Canada Cup on CTV.
Running has changed dramatically over the last 10 years, mainly because of what you put on your feet. Now, what science and technology have done for the running shoe, Mega does for the hockey skate. Mega, the first skate bioengineered to work with the foot, providing greater flexibility and faster power transfer. Mega, proven and preferred by hockey superstar Raymond Bork. Catch up with hockey's breakaway innovation, Mega, at your nearest Micron Mega dealer.
The Cup Coliseum in Hamilton. 7:03 left in regulation time. 5-5 Canada and the Soviets. Canada dumping it in, but Tisov back to get it. Pocket knocked him down, but he moved it to Larionov. And here come the Soviets. 3-on-3 break to Makarov. Makarov cutting in. Makarov right in, backhander wide. And Gilmore quickly moves it to Sutter. Sutter to center ice. To Tocket, but Tisov knocks it down. But Tisov in across the line, tipped back out by Sutter. And Canada with Tocket clear it down the ice. Here's number 2, Tisov. Flipping it up, Murphy knocks it down to Gretzky. Gretzky cutting in. Jack Lemieux held it in, but now Bekov back for the Soviets. Ahead to Kaminsky. Kaminsky trying to cut through. Hartsburg tied him up. Now Bekov behind the net. Gretzky has him in tow, and Lemieux comes up with it. Out to Gretzky. Gretzky with Croft and Coffey to center. Pass to Coffey. Breaking in. Coffey couldn't get around the defenseman. Delnov and the Soviets clear it out of there. Muir lets it go for Hartsburg to dump that icing. 5:45 left in regulation. This is the Labatt Canada Cup. Most of the hitting in the first period in this game, and the rest of his teammates weren't doing a heck of a lot of it. They have come along. Gretzky, Lemieux, and Croft for Canada. Semyonov against Gretzky on the faceoff. Nico says you've got to put your stick down. And Gretzky is saying Semyonov won't cooperate. Now they do drop the puck. Knocked back of a Soviet goal. Prop into the corner with Gusarov. Gusarov took him up. Now Lemieux getting it loose on the board. Lemieux centered to Gretzky. Burns couldn't get the shot off as Semyonov had him tied up. Now Murphy at the point. Shoots deflected by Prop and just wide. Gusarov then able to clear it. And Murphy chases back. Samak right behind him. Samak stealing it. But Bork was there to cover up. Bork for Canada, 5-12 left in regulation time. Here is Bork. Feeding it to Goulet, shot wide, Bork in to get the rebound. Back of the net to Goulet. Out in front to Lemieux, he's too well checked. And the Soviets clear it and get it to center ice. Bork back after it in a hurry. There is Nemchinov shooting it in. Bork gets it to Hartsburg, to Gretzky, who deflects it in. And Lemieux gets up into the fan collar above that. Gossetonov out into center ice for Kumalev, number eight. Into Priyaka. Hartsburg took him up. Coffey back for Canada. 4:28 left in regulation time. Coffey to Howardchuk. Cutting in. Howardchuk shoots off the blocker of Milnikov and then hit by a high stick. And that stops play. Well, they hit Howardchuk on the fly in full stride through center ice. The defenseman standing still on the play. And Howardchuk just barreled right in over the line. Got a good shot away. Milnikov, here he comes. This is the bag into that rush, and he just ducked past the defense. The speed does it. And they fired the shot off the blocker of Milnikov. But was knocked out of midair. A high stick, and the result is the faceoff will come all the way back down into the Team Canada into the ring. 4:20 left in regulation time. Absolute sellout here at the Cops Coliseum in Hamilton, 17,037. I think that's a little bit more than a sellout. There's the score, and we have, I mean, it had to be like this, Dan. We have simply...
Well, you knew the score was going to be 6-5 for somebody.
Yeah, that's right.
And the time in the bottom left-hand corner, 4:18 left in regulation play.
Here's Rochefort to Messier, to Anderson, gets it to center. Anderson to Gartner. Gartner cutting in, but offside on the far side was Gartner. And the faceoff will be at the Soviet line. Most of what you're seeing out there now unpenalized is the restraining type fouls. And I don't think that Don Koharski, being an NHL official, would try to call too much of that stuff. That would be something pretty gross and indecent for him to make a call now.
Here's Messier to Gartner. Crossman firing it in. Milnikov back to get it. Cleared it off onto the wing. Soviets clear it out, and here's Kurutov. Soviet with Kurutov cutting in on the left side. Tied up. Now centered. Man wide open, but elected to pass. And that allowed Crossman to recover and clear it out of there. Milnikov out of the net to feed it up to Makarov. And that's a two-line pass.
Now, Makarov is, I think, the best Soviet here tonight. He has been overshadowed somewhat by his line mate, Vladimir Kurutov, but tonight he is just dancing out there. He's doing so many things, and he is very, very strong and dominant in this game. Quite a sign to this building tonight. Some of them are great.
3:41 left in regulation time. Gretzky, Propp, and Lemieux. Coffey gets it to Hartsburg. Shoot from the point. Propp tried for the deflection, but it took off on him and went up into the crowd.
And because he steered it up there, the faceoff is going to be outside the blue line. I think that Viktor Tikhonov has aged a little bit in this tournament. This week. So have we. We're not going to get overtime again, are we, Dan?
Good chance of it.
Yeah.
3:36 left. Well, it's almost like you're playing sudden death overtime now.
That's right.
3:36 left in regulation time. Canada win the faceoff, drop it into their own zone, and Fuhr sets it up for Paul Coffey. Off the boards to Propp. Propp back to Coffey, tipped out, but shot right back in by Fedotov. Quickly cleared up. Like Canada again, now Homotop shooting it in. Coffey for Canada. Off the boards for Hartsburg. Four-man rush by Canada. Hartsburg to Propp. Shoot! Milnikov a save. Hartsburg was going for the net, but Milnikov held onto it.
Had the right idea. Feeling is that Milnikov doesn't hold a puck very well, although he certainly did there, taking it off the shaft of his stick and then holding it in his gloves. Throw it in, look for the rebound, and here's a good quick shot by Propp. Let it go. And they said the right idea with Hartsburg going for the net, but Milnikov hung onto the rebound. Brian Propp right down there, next to Mario Lemieux, playing a good game tonight.
Here's Sutter with Pocket and Howard shot for Canada. Semyonov on the faceoff against Brent Sutter. Sutter gets the draw to Murphy. Murphy shoots, that's blocked. And then Seaman split it out of there with his hand. But Canada gets possession, then it's waved off. Murphy fires it back in. Hubalev in to get it. Sutter behind the net. Tied up by Hubalev. Look at Sutter battle. To Howard Chuck. Back on the point for shoots up high. Into the crowd. And we're down to 2:36. Left and overtime, or in sudden, or in regulation. Think I'm thinking of overtime?
Yeah. We've seen so much of it. Lay Jean-Perron, the fourth round. Co-coach with Lars Denis, or at least Keenan, Mike Keenan. Five, 2:36. Left in regulation time. And they're going to call a timeout. There you see the signal from Victor Tikhonov. He has called a timeout here. That'll give, but I don't, you know, when you see Gretzky out there in the middle of a shift anyway, I don't know whether I want to make a timeout call at that particular time. Give those guys a little extra rest.
Well, he must be thinking of Makarov and Kurutov and his key people. Yeah, but it does give some of the Team Canada aces a chance to catch their breath. 2:36 left in regulation time.
Right in the foreground there, you see Makarov. Now, Keenan has got something going down there. He wants to flood one side of the ice. Move everybody up one side. See what happens. Off the face-off.
Gretzky, Lemieux, and Messier will be up front. Now at the last second, he changes his mind.
Well, when you look at this 10 years from now and you say 6-5, 6-5, 6-5, you say, boy, those must have been pretty awful defensive games. I'd have to put it the other way and say they were a terrific offensive game.
Here's Messier. He's out there with Gartner and Anderson. Soviet Kostatonov coming up with it to Kruta. 2.5 left in regulation time. Good defensive play by Rochefort to break it up. Now Patisa in center ice. Patisa loses to Gartner. Gartner cuts behind the net. Gets it in front of Anderson. A shot. Loose puck coming to Messier. He fired it around. Here's Anderson again, but tipped away by Kostatonov. Soviet trying to clear it. Messier held it in. Now Larionov breaking out to Makarov. And Rochefort is there for Canada. Takes Makarov out and Crossman takes over. Crossman flipping it up. 1:50 left in regulation time. Kravchuk shoots it to center. Canada taking control with perfect. Cross ice to Coffey. Coffey scooping it in. Hustling it after it is Gretzky. And the Soviet player got there first, so it's icing against Canada. 1:36 left in regulation time. And a face-off deep in Team Canada's end of the ring.
Well, now it's hold-on time. It'll be Gretzky will take the draw down there. And they're going to send Bekov out again. He's their top man in that department. Now you have to control it.
Chuck, Lemieux, and Gretzky all center icing on the ice, and it looks as though Howard Chuck will draw the assignment against Becca. Howard Chuck wins it in. Here's Lemieux poking at the center. Lemieux ahead to Gretzky. Has Murphy with him on a 2-on-1 to Lemieux. And on goal, he shoots, he scores! Mario Lemieux with 1:26 remaining.
This But you don't give Lemieux that kind of room. But hold it before the celebration gets too far into the night here. We've got 1:26 left, and this is a great hockey team. The Team Canada is playing, and they can come back.
What did I say earlier about Gretzky loading the gun and Lemieux pulling the trigger?
Yes,
there it was,
true.
In living color.
Tikhonov was down talking to... And, you know, this is a common sight. A goal is given up, and he turns around. Rather than rallying his guys, he starts giving people heck. And some poor defenseman is really catching it in the air right now.
They are a little excited here in Hamilton.
Here we see it again. Number 8 is Murphy, but it's Gretzky. Murphy's the decoy. And there's the shot. Right out of position and unable to make a play with Stelnov.
Mario Lemieux's 11th goal of this tournament. Canada takes a 6-5 lead with 1:26 remaining.
Look at Gretzky now. He's saying, look, we've got a 1:26 left to his teammate Glenn Anderson. Now hold him. That's what he's saying, because they've scored in the final minute before.
Lemieux from Gretzky, 18:34 the time. Lemieux's 11th goal. They are standing at the top Coliseum. Now the Soviets with 1:26 left. Nechinov against Messier. And they'll toss Messier out of there.
Nobody's sitting in this place.
Now Messier allowed to take the faceoff against Nechinov.
Gartner breaks away for Canada with Anderson, 2-on-1. Pass to Anderson and a goal. Can't get it in front and hits Gartner. Gartner with Milnikov caught out of there, putting center.
Now, Soviet Kucherov around on the boards to Fedotov. Here they come to center. Bumalak, number 8. Long shot. Your steer to the side. Priyakin. Bumped by Rochefort. 1 minute left in regulation time. Soviet trying to center. Rochefort there to clear it. And Fedotov has to go back after it. With now 50 seconds left. 6-5, Canada leading. Both teams changing on the fly. Kostatonov to Larionov. He's upended. Petisov shoots it in. Murphy there to clear it. Petisov holding it in. Shot blocked. Petisov again. Blocked again, this time by Messier. And Messier flips it to center. 30 seconds left. Here's Kostatonov. To Petisov, broken up by Messier. Now a fired in by the Soviets. Coffey back with 20 seconds left. And Canada cleared out of there. 15 seconds left. Kostatonov back to get it. Dukarukov. Messier breaks it up. Messier with 7 seconds left. Now Makarov. 4 seconds left. Team Canada wins 6-5. And look at that celebration.
grinders we talked so much about back in the early days of this tournament came to the fore. Tockett with a goal and an assist. Murphy with a goal and two assists. Prop with a goal and an assist. Sutter, a goal and an assist. And Hourchuck with a goal and an assist.
Team
Canada outshooting the Soviets in the third period, 15-6. They outshot them every period. In the game, 46-23, the total shots in favor of Canada. And Team Canada wins 6-5 on Mario Lemieux's 11th goal. May we never, ever hear a word about Mario Lemieux's ability or desire again. Is the scene in Hamilton. Momentarily, we're going to go to the ice surface. Let's try and go down there now for the final ceremony.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now ready for the presentation of the players of the game. Could we please have the photographer's cooperation, please? To make the presentation of the Player of the Game Awards, I would like to ask the from the Canon Camera Company, Mr. Paul Mather. And the District Sales Manager for Labatt, Ontario Breweries, Mr. Jim Steele. Before we do make the presentation of these two awards, wouldn't you agree with me to salute the two teams for one of the best series ever played? The player of the game for Team Soviet Union, who will receive a Canon EOS camera. He was tremendous throughout the series. Le joueur là-bas du match pour l'équipe soviétique recevra une caméra Canon. Number two, l'éliminateur Vyacheslav Pekisov. Player of the game for Team Canada, who will receive the complete set of 10 1988 Olympic Winter Game coins, courtesy of Canadian Tire. Le joueur là-bas du match, il recevra un ensemble complet de monnaie olympique. Team Canada, number 10, Dale Hourchuck. To present the Canada Cup trophy please welcome as center ice the tournament chairman Mr. Alan Eagleson. He is joined by Dr. Gunther Zabetsky, president of the International Ice Hockey Federation, and Monsieur Pierre Desjardins, president of the Brasil Labatt du Canada. Canada Cup will be presented to the captain of Team Canada and the whole team, Wayne Gretzky.
Yeah.
for the national anthem of the winning team. Let's once again hear Mr. Michael Burgess with O Canada.
September is sensational on TSN. The pennant drive stays alive, and you'll follow Canada's two favorite teams as they head into the heat of battle. Plus, the Saturday game of the week tracks main contenders all the way down to the October showdown. The NFL starts to roll with preseason matchups and a new show, NFL Prime Time, to complete the picture. Don't miss the championship final from the CSL on TSN, or Grand Slam tennis action from the U.S. Open in Flushing Meadow. And the Class of 87 gets underway with CIAU and NCAA football matchups. See the final round of the Payne Weber World Series Seniors Golf. NASCAR's Winston Cup Series continues from Dover Downs with the Delaware 500. And kart racing meets at Lexington for the Mid-Ohio 200. Closer to home, the Stampeders visit Iverwind Stadium to battle the Tiger Cats on their home turf. For sports action, look no further. From tee to green, television's best golf coverage is on TSN. The greatest tournaments, including Grand Slam events, the U.S. Open, the British Open, and the PGA Championship. Outstanding PGA, LPGA, and Senior Tour golfers. featuring Jack Nicklaus, Pat Bradley, and Arnold Palmer. TSN's live coverage from the world's most spectacular courses brings you closer than ever to the players and the action.
Look at that putt break.
Now over 80 national and local TV guide magazines include complete TSN program listings. If you've had problems finding out what's on TSN, check your local newsstand or newspaper supplement for the latest edition in your area and watch for this TSN on-air program guide for last-minute changes. Now, let's take a look at what's coming up on TSN.
This is round three of the 1986 National Finals Rodeo from Las Vegas, Nevada. Some of the best competition in our sport of rodeo. Hello, everyone. I'm Hadley Barrett.
And I'm Bob Weiss. And some surprises came to rodeo fans as some of our top contestants kind of ran into troubles in round one and two. We hope they can pick up extra dollars here, Hadley, in round three.
Well, bringing us some of the live reports from the arena floor is one of our rodeo sports authorities and a former Miss Rodeo America, Miss Pam Minnig. Pam?
From down here on the arena floor, I'm able to bring you the activity firsthand. This sport of rodeo is like no other. There's no timeouts, no stretchers brought onto the field. These cowboys are true athletes. In round two, Monty Henson bucked off his horse into the chute with another bronc. As soon as they pulled him out of the way, the rodeo went on. Back to you, Hadley.
Going into the third round of the bareback riding, we're going to set the scene for you, and it looks like this. Starting from 15 and going up, Jeff Hart, Dave Peters, George Mesmer, Dunham, and Young as we look at the top 15. And now bear in mind, we are going into the third round as you see them now. We have rearranged some as a result of the big money at the NFR here in 86. So for you folks at home watching on the screen, you can see exactly how it goes. Well, Bobby, we're on our way.
All right, Jeff Hart from Porta, Colorado. Here's a man that's yet to pick up any dollars. He's on Myers Bartee Shedrack, the name of the horse, for 8 seconds. They're judged 1 to 25 on each side for the horse and 1 to 25 on each side for the rider. From Marengar officials, we saw a flag down on the field there. We'll have to get the credits here from our judges and find out if it was a disqualification. It was, Hadley, a no score. That means that the feet must be over the point of the shoulders, that first jump out of the chute, to give the animal the advantage. Evidently, that was not done here in the eyes of our Wrangler officials, and it disqualified him.
This is Robin Burwash out of Alberta. At Gage and Moon to the Groundy String out of California is the horse. Oh, this is a nice ride.
We might explain for you folks, too, at home, that if you haven't watched television or a rodeo that much, I know you've watched TV if you're over the age of five, that they are scored 1 to 25, as we told you, for the horse and 1 to 25 for the rider on each side. The free hand must remain free at all times, and Burwash shows it how it's done here, and it looks like it's going to be enough to go to the lead, Hadley, with a 73 marking. You're mad.
Danny Bray. Oh, look at Danny.
Here's a man who we might say is a neighbor to Las Vegas, right over here in Henderson, Nevada. And he is doing it right. Brady comes in here looking good on Snake Eyes of Kelsey.
Do they like this guy here or what? I can tell you the in-house audience is showing us what they think of him. Well, I'll tell you, they have reason to. Look at the control that Brady's showing us here. Now, we're looking for something over a 73 score, and I think we have got it. It is a 78 score. The Nevada man is now in the lead.
Yes, and Hadley, that adds to his $2,600 that he had already won. So that, if he wins another here, we're talking $8,400 for first place. How about the number one man in the world? All-around champion standings, as well as right up in here. has a chance for the bareback riding. This is Lewis Fields of Elk Ridge, Utah. And colorful outfit he has on here this week.
Well, I'll tell you about Field. He's already won almost $9,000, and we're into the third round. He will show you that he is here to mean business. He did last year, and I'm sure he has the same thing on his mind.
That was Watson of Stephen Brothers Rodeo Company. We get to see it here again. Beautiful color-coordinated cowboys. These guys are styling. They might be at the rodeo, but they get their clothes on Rodale Drive.
Ah, you got it.
71.
We're going to slide right back down to the chutes, and we're pinpointing on Jim Dunn, one of Canadian's greatest cowboys. He's the reigning champ of Canada, and Dunn is looking good again tonight. Boy, can this guy ride? I'd hope to tell you. Now, Jim has already placed twice in the first two rounds. This guy carried a pretty good cushion here from the rodeo in Regina that we offered reference to earlier. He won second in the bareback riding up there, so he's looking good for the 87 year already.
And Hadley, in our first round, we saw him there with his horse Trip coming out. And that was something, fell down. It could have ruined his whole national finals. He's come back here, a 78, to tie for the lead. I bet this is kind of a race, the action that happened to him here in our first round.
And you know, part of that ride has to be credited to Vern Franklin's good horse Summer Wind, and Jim would tell you that quickly. This is Marvin Garrett. This is the youngster from Wyoming, and he'll back away from nobody. He is hot. I love the way this kid rides. Boy, I tell you, he's going to get somebody's hair.
Ouch.
Ooh, no.
Yes, right into that wall. Bad, Hadley. Right into where the brace is at, too. His head hit hard.
Now, he's getting up slowly. He's getting up very slowly, and I'm sure that Marvin would like to kind of shake this injury off, but it may be more serious than that.
Don Andrews, one of our sports medicine program from Justin, is on hand here. We thank them very much. Here's the little guy, 140 pounds, 5'7", 23 years old. He is tough, but when you meet up with them steel fences, I'll speak for myself. They aren't all that good to deal with.
Well, I hope that that will not hamper his performance.
Well, here he comes for that riding style. They mark him as 71 here. He has won over $7,350.
All right. We're going to take a look at Mr. Smooth next as we go back to the chutes. And there is Marvin walking back, thank heavens. This is Clint Corey. I tell you, he hasn't had a foot out of place for the last 6 months, and I don't think he does tonight. Look at Corey. He says, watch me, my friends. I came here to win this thing, and he is still in the lead. He has won over $7,000 already, has a $2,000 lead over Louis Field. And he, Louis Field a moment ago, as you know, took a shot at him, and this guy needs to be up in those high 70s. May be there. Look at this style, Bob.
73.
Well, a little disappointing.